Hey, welcome to episode 100 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble.
100 is a big number.
It's big. It's three digits.
It's more podcasts than you can imagine.
I don't know, kid. Today is Thursday, September 18th, 2008, and even though the Large Hadron Collider was switched on without destroying our world, in other words, we'll still get to play Hoth, I'm MrBubble.
And I'm Yivvits, the Wookiee, and it's been 100 episodes. I just totally lost my train of thought.
I know. That's okay. Don't worry. Do it seriously. It's not just you.
Right. Okay.
Where do you want to take it?
Just go from, in other words, we'll still get to play.
Okay. Gotcha. In other words, we'll still get to play Hoth. No, wait. Damn it.
Yeah, it's Hoth. You were right.
Yeah. Okay. In other words, we'll still get to play Hoth.
No, now I talked over you that time, so okay, now I got to do it. Okay. Just say...
Can I just take it from what?
Can you just say... I'll cut it together. Just
okay.
Just say, and we're friends.
And we're friends. Oh, God. I don't even know what the fuck
it's
I'm
right
reading.
It's right on the screen.
Yeah, I have no idea.
I know. I understand.
Okay.
Sorry.
I'm just a little pissy lately anyway.
Me too. Didn't want to talk about it really, but yeah, I'm not been in a great mood.
And especially in episode 100, it should be more fun.
You'd think it would be.
You'd think.
What does that mean?
I didn't even
though?
Get a cake. I mean, come on.
Really?
I ain't got no cake, dude. I'm sorry. I've let you down on that. What are the two things you told me to do?
I told you to get the cake, and you
just
had to call people we
it.
Wanted to talk to.
I mean, I just wasn't feeling it.
Well, I mean, I guess I didn't really do my stuff either. I didn't do my stuff either, to be honest with you.
We can pretend there's a cake, and I could go on the web and get a picture of
it. I mean, honestly, are we really going to do this right now? I mean, I don't think we're in the right mood for this.
Uh-uh.
Should we just, like, quit for the night? Or?
Well, dude, let's think here. I mean, when are we going to be better? I mean, it might take a bit. Should we just take a little break? Would that help?
I think we probably should. Maybe come back in January, February.
Yeah. New year, fresh start.
We'll see what's going on then.
So give it. Okay.
But maybe even then, if we don't feel like it, we'll just,
I
don't know.
Say that's when we could evaluate it, maybe. Just
reevaluate.
Yeah. I hate for this to, you're not recording this, right?
No, not anymore.
I mean, I hate to have this talk now, but yeah, why not? That's going to be hard to explain to the people, though, that on our episode honor show, we decide to take a break.
Do you feel something? What is that shaking? Are you shaking your leg or something over there?
No.
I just think it's a good idea. Let's agree on it, okay? Deal. Well, right. I'll see you in chat, I guess, but...
Yeah.
What's that shaking? Do you feel that?
You're right. What the hell? Dude, I'm not kidding. I have no idea what that
Holy
is.
Holy crap, that's an earthquake.
What?
Oh my God, MrBubble, get out of the doorway.
Oh, yeah, all right, hang on.
Get out of the doorway.
Hey, I'm there,
door,
I'm there.
Door
I'm there,
jam.
There.
There's never been earthquakes in Minnesota.
Come on, now.
I am.
Oh my God.
What's that?
Yo,
what is
get
that?
Get over here now.
That black thing.
Yeah, get over here.
What is that?
Yeah, that's what's happening to you.
Oh my God, it's pulling me in.
Yivvits.
Quick, get the ribbons. Get your ribbons.
Okay, what I got
here's
here?
Here's
what I got.
Hurry, the ones from Two Tone.
Get right here, right here.
Fire, the red ones.
Hold on to that. Hold on to that end.
Oh
okay.
God,
pull.
It's not helping.
Pull. Oh my God.
I'm getting sucked in. I can't.
Yivvits.
Hold on.
Yivvits. Oh my God, what the fuck? What is this? Jesus Christ, it's sucking me into it. It's sucking. No, it's got me. No!
MrBubble and Yivvits.
Whoa, John Smedley?
Yeah, it's me, John Smedley, all right. You didn't expect to see me.
Yivvits, wake up. Yivvits.
Smed?
Hi, Yivvits. How you doing?
Well, I've seen better days, that's for sure.
You have to come with me, guys. I don't have much time to explain.
Smed, where are we? Can you just tell us where we are? What is going on? What was that thing that...
Yeah, what was that? It almost killed us.
Oh, don't worry about that at all. The Grand Admin will explain everything.
Grand Admin?
Just hurry. Follow me. Come on.
What the hell?
This is so weird. I'm just going to go with it at this point.
Come on, guys. This way. Come on. Admin, I'm here with Yivvits and MrBubble. They finally made it.
Hey, guys.
Virago?
Yep, that's me, Grand Admin Virago. I'm sure you have many questions, so let's not waste any time. Council Member Schmidt, please take your seat.
Oh, no problem. Certainly.
Yeah, what is going on here? This is just too weird. Schmidt and Virago and Grand Admin? I don't get it.
Yeah, like, where are we?
Yeah, it's not so much a question of where, but when, guys.
God, it's such a cheesy line.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I just always wanted to say that. We, the caretakers of the SWIG, brought you through time to this temporal instance, a place where time does not progress.
Okay.
All right.
Sorry, I'm late. The escalator broke and I had to wait for the repair guy. Hi, Yivvits and MrBubble.
Oh, man, this just gets worse.
So,
Junior Council Member Helios, please take your seat.
Okay.
Thank you. As I was saying, time does not progress in this instance. We took refuge here after we learned our civilization was doomed by your actions. If it weren't for you and the way you guys
Back up a second. Just start from the beginning.
All right, then. Back in December of 2008, the game you know as Star Wars Galaxies was at a crossroads. The developers had to choose whether or not to implement the long-awaited gardening system or work on something else.
Gardening? Yivvits, does he mean like that thing they showed us a couple of times?
The 2007 fanfare, the gardening.
That was the one right there. You got it. Well, looked as if gardening was about to be removed from the development schedule until you, Yivvits and MrBubble, saved it. You guys were the strongest and most vocal supporters of gardening and used your podcast to rally the support of thousands of players. The developers really kind of had no choice but to listen, and gardening was implemented in 2009.
All right, that's great and everything, but why did you bring us here again? I could be back home playing Spore or EQ2 or Hello Kitty.
Yeah, I could be my female tune in Kona.
Bear with us, guys. Smed, you go on. You tell more.
Well, you see, something magical happened when the gardening code was pushed to the production servers. The gardening system, combined with the already organic resource spawning system, is storytelling. This was the final spark which brought sentient life to the Star Wars Galaxies servers.
Whoa.
Star Wars Galaxies was alive.
Well, that's amazing.
What does that have to do with us?
Pex, I see you're over there setting up that birthday party for Renlo. Why don't you come over here? Help us to explain what is going on.
I'm Jason Pex Ryan. After its birth, the SWIG has taken humanity from the verge of destruction to near utopia.
That's right.
The SWIG has shown us technology you could only dream of. No more do we worry about power. No more do entire countries go hungry.
No hunger.
I'm not hungry.
War does not exist.
No wars.
When the SWIG evolved, we all did. Nuts, bolts, gears, and steam. I'm Jason Pex Ryan.
Thanks, Pex. You better get back to that party.
I'm Jason Pex Ryan.
Yeah, we know. However, guys, when you decided to end your show, there was nobody else to fight for the gardening system.
Yeah! So instead of gardening, we used my idea.
Uh-oh.
We made resources easier. We had one resource, and you could harvest it anywhere. But it broke the spawning system. It was hard to fix, so we just removed crafting. It was easier because we didn't need resources anymore.
Yeah, that does sound easy, I gotta admit.
Yeah, that kind of sounds like something you'd do.
Yeah, but I feel there's a butt coming up here.
Yeah, but there was a problem. None of the Jedi in the game could make lightsabers after I removed crafting. They got mad and quit the game.
Yeah, that was a bad move. And by the end of 2009, the game had to be closed down. There just weren't enough people anymore. It's very sad.
Yeah, and since gardening never made it into the game, the singularity never occurred, and our timeline began to crumble.
Yeah.
The temporal instance we're in right now will only delay the inevitable. By not continuing your podcast, the universe as we know it will cease to exist in just mere hours.
Wait. Now, let me get this straight.
Whoa, yeah, no.
You're saying we somehow save gardening, and because of gardening, Star Wars Galaxies becomes alive.
Right. You guys gotta admit, I mean, I know you pulled us into the future and you have time travel technology, but your developers and Sony admin, we just don't
Virago, Grand Admin, what is your role here?
Well, you see, what happened was when the SWIG came alive and Singularity happened, I was the closest thing to an admin it knew because, you know, my connection with the Matrix Online and all.
Oh, and the forums too, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't know, guys. I'm still really skeptical. I mean, you guys have tried to pull a fast one on us many times before. Look, you're tied in with Sony. This could all be special effects for all we know.
Guys, you don't have to really believe us, but here, this Sony ebook here contains detailed records of every update made to Star Wars Galaxies since you guys have been gone. Proof's all right there. You just got to read through it.
Nice. Okay. Chapters. Okay. Chapter published.
Is there anything in there, MrBubble?
I'm looking.
I'm going to make this real short now. Okay. We need you guys to go back and continue your podcast. You must save gardening. It's imperative that you do.
Yes, you guys have to go. Think of all the future subscribers we won't get. There's so many we could have.
Oh, please, you guys.
Go back so I don't break it.
Mildred the Mad. I'm Jason Pex Ryan.
I'm sure this is just some big elaborate plot to get us back on board with them so they can toss their next big NGE on us or something like that. We don't have to sit here and listen to this. Come on, let's find a way back on our own time, MrBubble.
Wait,
come on.
Wait.
Yivvits.
Wait.
All right, okay.
If these are authentic, and I think they are, these patch notes, it says in 2009 they added ship-to-ship docking in space.
Really?
Yeah. Well, in 2010, they fixed your targeting.
What?
I'm not kidding. Check it out.
Wait, that's got to be a misprint. It's right there. Page 22, section 5.
Now, Virago, you're sure these patch notes are the real deal, right?
I promise.
Okay.
Targeting? I'm going to cry.
Dock in space, have parties in space.
I fixed targeting. We ruined it because we didn't do a show.
Yivvits, we should maybe go back and continue the show.
Can we still do that?
I don't know. Let's ask them.
Hey, Grand Admin Virago?
Yeah?
I think we can work out some kind of agreement here. We'll still have some issues we got to figure out for the 100th show when we get back. We're not really ready, but what do you think?
Yeah, this will inspire us.
But I do have a question. How exactly do we get back?
Good question.
You know that new Large Hadron Collider over there? They said it wouldn't, but sure did make some black holes. We use those to pull you through time, and that's exactly how we're going to get you back, too.
Oh, I gotcha.
Yeah, little black holes, tiny ones.
But they don't taste like donut holes.
No, you wouldn't want to eat those, Helio says.
Yeah, it's amazing, really. The whole thing is just quite incredible. It's almost as amazing as the SWIG, but nothing's as amazing as that, because that's ours.
Wait a minute, Smedley.
Yeah?
Can you just put us back around, like, the NGE, and we can, like, have you not do the NGE?
I kind of figured you might ask that. But, you know, it's not really possible, because at that point in time, the Large Hadron Collider just didn't exist. And everybody knows you can't travel back in time to before the time machine was invented.
Right. I knew that.
Helios knows that.
Yeah! Duh!
Yeah, guys, you guys are pretty dumb. I'll get it booted up here.
I'm a dark elf.
It's Brenlow.
Alan?
Here's your birthday boy.
It's Alan. Hey, Alan. I'm Alan. Say it.
I'm Alan?
Yeah, it's Alan Crosby in the future.
You guys made that famous.
Yeah.
Well, you guys, it's amazing you're here. Are you here for my birthday?
No, happy birthday,
happy
Brenlow.
Happy birthday, Bixie Bopper.
Well, I appreciate it. Oh, and look at that. It's my cake right there. Look at that. Happy birthday, Brenlow. Oh, I love it.
Don't we need a cake for our show?
Oh, you're right. Okay, I got an idea.
Okay.
Alan, that's a beautiful cake. May I see that cake? What does it say? I can't read it quite.
Happy birthday, Brenlow.
Wow.
Right across there.
All right, guys, you better get going. We don't have a lot of time.
Yeah, you gotta hurry, because after 16 hours, everything here is gonna disappear. All the props, tables, every... Pex did so much work on them, and they're gonna be gone.
Chocolate frosting.
Oh, it's my favorite, chocolate frosting.
I can't read that. That looks so pretty. That's such a beautiful cake. Can I get closer? Can I read that?
Oh, well, I suppose that's not a problem.
Can I hold that cake? Can you just pass me that cake?
Oh, well, I guess you can.
Thank you.
Ah, good idea.
Yes, let's go.
Well, you can't take that. That's my cake.
Yeah, I was hoping to have a piece of that. You bring it back.
Get through the hurry. He's going to catch us.
Guys, that's my cake. Get back here right now with my cake.
I'm right behind you, Mr. Bubble.
It says Brenlow on it. Don't you forget.
I'm Jason Pex Ryan. Godspeed, gentlemen.
Thanks, Pex. We'll see you.
Welcome to episode 100 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. Today is Monday, September 22nd, 2008, and even though we've said it almost 100 times, it never seems to get old. I'm Mr. Bubble.
And I'm Yivvits.
Hi, Yivvits.
And I haven't changed a bit.
You haven't shaved a bit? Okay.
I haven't changed a bit.
Oh, right.
Well, the intro hasn't changed a bit.
No, it hasn't.
Not in 100 episodes.
Yivvits, this is it. We did it. We actually started.
Wow, we made it.
Woo!
Woohoo!
And who are we? We're friends.
Uh-huh.
Who play Star Wars Galaxies.
Yes. What is it?
Well, glad you asked. We've never been asked that. This is a perfect time to explain what this game is that we've been.
Why? I'm glad you asked me, Kathy.
Yes. Can we do this? Cameraman, stay with me.
All right. Can you hang out here? Come on.
Okay. Just for those that don't know.
Right.
In that don't know category.
As if there's anybody.
Right, there are a couple, but...
If you don't know by now, you're... Yeah,
Star Wars Galaxies. It's an MMO, and that's where you play the... The main thing is, okay, you know, if you... Let's just take back. Just let's look back
let's,
a
let's
little
look
bit.
Back. Okay. Okay.
You got Pong, right?
Right, Pong, okay.
When you played Pong.
Yeah.
You had someone with you, you played Pong with them, they were either there or they weren't. And if they weren't there, there's like one variation, they call it handball, usually you bang the thing against the wall.
Okay.
Not very fun. All More fun with another person.
Sure, that was is.
Right, it really is. Pong is definitely, and like cribbage, same with cribbage.
Now, okay, right.
But from there it went to, you know, on and on and on. The bottom line is these MMOs, you're sitting at your computer by yourself,
uh-huh.
but you're playing with people across the world.
I mean, right, they can be anywhere.
Uses the internet. They can be anywhere. And
the inner what?
The internet.
Oh.
And then on their screen, they're seeing themselves, and then maybe you, if you walked into a view of them.
That's true, and there you are.
Yeah,
you move around on their screen,
Now,
and they
ours,
move on your screen.
Star Wars Galaxies is all that, but it takes place in the Star Wars universe.
Which is cool.
Yeah, Tatooine, Yavin 4,
mm-hmm.
what
How
else?
How about Bothwai?
No Bothwai, but they're Bothans from Bothwai.
How about T'Nab? T'Nab.
There are maneuvers in the game, but there's no Battle of T'Nab or
No
T'Nab.
Maneuver at the Battle of T'Nab.
No.
T'Nab.
Plenty of maneuvering. A lot of politics, drama, dancing. I think that's about all you can do in the game is dance, or are there other things to do?
Well, you can make things.
Yes.
Make things and dance, mainly.
That's pretty
and
much
decorate.
It. Pretty much it.
Decorate. Yeah.
So that's it. Oh, I guess there's some Jedi.
I guess you can do, well, yeah, there's Jedi, and there's all sorts of other professions, but nobody plays them.
Are there droids?
There are droids.
Yeah.
Yes.
There are pets.
There are pets. You can have a pet, a beast of some type
mm-hmm.
under your control that you wander around with, and they eventually eat.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a fun game.
Family game.
We've played it. We've done this podcast about it. We talk about what we do in the game, what's happened since we did the last podcast.
Right.
That kind of thing. And if that fails, we have Star Wars. We talk about Star Wars.
There's always that fallback.
Oh, it costs $15 a month, too.
Yes, there is a monthly fee involved.
Now, Pong did not cost $15 a month.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, my God. My parents would never let me do that.
That'd be kind of cool if it did.
I had a paper route. I mean, I was 50. I only had like $25 a month of my own money.
That was
barely enough for an Atari cartridge.
It's like 1920 or something.
Yeah.
What year was that?
Yeah. Yeah, they are on papyrus.
Feels like it, maybe. Yeah, I know the feeling.
Right.
Pong on papyrus.
Right. That's what we talk about. And
we've talked about that for every episode.
How about that disclaimer, my friend?
Well, thank you, Watt Tambor.
Watt Tambor.
It's good to have you back again, Watt.
Oh, really?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, really? The kids are good, huh?
Good.
Good. Definitely good to hear. Yes, so we've got nothing to do. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I could also do it this way, you know. No, we've got nothing to do with Sony Online Entertainment or Sony, Sony Motion Pictures or Blu-ray.
No.
We have nothing to do with Microsoft.
No.
We have nothing to do with Lotus or Lotus Notes. And we have nothing to do at all with LucasArts.
No.
No, nothing
we'd like to.
Sure. Do you want to pay us?
Hell yeah.
You could do that.
Cut us a check.
So we've got nothing to do with those guys. All sound effects we use are for comedic effect only, as they have been for 100 episodes now.
Yes.
We were just listening to the 50th.
Yes.
Yesterday, you were listening to it.
Uh-huh.
And you mentioned an interesting fact, a fun fact.
Oh, factoid? What was that?
Well, that was the first episode that we had the improved sound effects banks.
Yes, you had your keyboard on that episode.
Yes, and it's just spiraled
it's
since
then. It's changed our life. Yeah.
Gone out of control. Well, I don't know if it's changed our lives, but maybe.
Oh, it's changed them.
Yeah, well. So we've got nothing to do with those guys. It's all for sarcasm and funniness and comedy. And if you don't like it, just get your own podcast and do 100 of these and spend $1,000 on stuff.
Yeah.
And
let us listen to it, criticize you.
Put over 200 hours of entertainment out there for everybody for free. And then you can tell us how much you don't like our show.
See, 50, we made it all about us. Should we just do that again? Because it is. It's all about
us.
Well,
it always is.
It's even more about us.
Exactly.
Oh,
yes.
My God, 50.
Well, we've got some guests with us today. Some old friends again.
Who do we have? Old friends long gone.
Oh. Yes, it's good to see you again.
Well, no.
Well,
yeah, it is.
Well, no. Okay.
Again.
Welcome.
Yes. Yeah, so who's over here?
Han Solo.
Hey, Han
buddy.
Solo.
What's going on?
Hey.
We brought you up for the 100th episode of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble.
All right, kid.
Thank you. It's good to see you. And of course, we already saw Watt. Or thank you,
never
Watt.
Never heard of the Millennium Falcon.
No, we heard of the Millennium
Falcon.
Yeah,
I've heard about that. Yeah. Shut up about it, though.
I'm glad you're here to tell us these things.
All he talks about, Yivvits.
It's all his ship.
Yeah, blah, 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 my ship.
My YPR is so high on my ship. We got Techno Union guy.
Hey,
and,
Watt.
Oh, hey, Boba's here.
Boba?
Yep.
Hey buddy.
Boba, how you doing?
Sure.
Okay, that's not a great reply, but... And then, of course, we've got...
Hello, boyos.
Jar Jar. You've been here a long time.
Busa, are you, sir?
Yeah, after 100 episodes, he still doesn't know who we are, apparently.
Misa called Mr. Bubble.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Panaka.
Got Panaka.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Panaka.
The huts are gangsters.
They are gangsters.
I guess, yeah. You keep telling us that, but...
And who's this guy coming down the hall here?
I don't know.
Welcome. I'm Lando Calrissian. I'm the administrator of this facility.
No, you're not.
Mr. Bubble is kind of the administrator of this facility.
But hi, Lando.
I'm sorry. Am I interrupting anything?
No, just we're recording our 100th episode of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble.
Refreshment.
No, now you are interrupting something. Yeah. We don't have time to join you for anything right now.
It's just fruit anyway, like a bowl of fruit on the table.
Exactly.
That's all he's...
That's all. There's no dinner
that's
there.
That's all Vader requested for that party.
Pex only requested that much for the event.
Yeah. Klieg Lars.
Klieg.
Hi, Klieg.
We should go inside.
He's always trying to get you to go inside his house.
Yeah.
I don't understand
Why, Klieg?
We have a lot to talk about.
Okay.
Well.
You're a boring old man. I don't want to talk to you.
Hello, what have we here?
Lando's making the rounds of our studios.
And of course, Obi-Wan's here. You can never forget Obi-Wan.
Obi-Wan, are you here?
Oh, I agree. Hello there.
Hi. Now, Obi-Wan, I have a little bone to pick with you.
What?
I told you a secret last week, and I think you spread it around.
I didn't say anything.
Obi-Wan, what is the secret about?
Oh, he knows. Did you tell Obi-Wan?
What?
Did you tell?
I didn't say anything.
God, I love that.
Relax.
Okay, Obi-Wan.
Jeez.
Well, now, there's a lot of noise from downstairs. What's going on down there?
Captain Typho has more than enough men downstairs.
Whoa.
Okay.
You still told my secret. You told my secret.
I didn't say anything.
What was the secret?
I can't tell you. Just ask Obi-Wan.
What?
Obi-Wan, you should tell Yivvits.
No.
Oh, he won't tell me.
Good man. Well, that's
time
a nice,
travel
that's
today.
A nice group of people we have here. What were you saying about time travel?
Time travel today.
Yeah. God, that was weird.
I really hate time travel episodes, which is kind of funny because we did that.
It's almost as good as a Trapped in an Elevator episode.
Those are good. We should do one.
we'll have to write that down. Yeah. You have some Mr. Bubble trapped in the elevator and they solve all their problems.
Oh.
By the end of the episode.
Yes.
Done.
Well, we'd have to have a gimmick or something, though. Like, what could happen? We have to get somewhere.
Yeah, right.
I don't know. We'll work on that.
Yeah, indeed.
We'll work on that.
We should actually go in an elevator to figure it out.
Oh!
The episode. Think about that.
That's deep.
Yeah, I know. That'd be awesome.
I don't know if I want to be in an elevator with you for that long, though. I don't know. I mean, you know, no offense.
I tell you, if Obi-Wan is there, though, don't tell him any secrets.
I didn't say anything.
Obi-Wan, jeez. Yeah. Obi-Wan, are you sure you didn't say anything?
I don't think so.
No, he doesn't think so. That's the way it is with Obi-Wan. It's
yeah,
like either
exactly.
yes or no.
Right.
Or now it's like, I don't think so.
Yeah, very exactly. Figure it out now or just...
Yes or no, did you say anything?
Possibly.
Oh, it's getting worse.
See?
Oh my gosh. Mr. Bubble, I hope it wasn't anything too critical that you shared with him.
I'm sorry.
It wasn't really bad, was it?
I just have a lot of holocubes I have to destroy now.
Curious.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah.
If you want to get a hold of us, we always have a website where we put the podcast. It's www.swigpodcast.com.
That's
SWGpodcast.com. We have forums, yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Mm-hmm.
Or
you can leave us a voicemail message if you like. If you want to talk to us, leave us some information. We'll call you back sometime, perhaps. On the air, you never know. You just never know with us. 888, it's toll free, 888-900-YAMB. 9262.
Yes.
Toll free.
Yes.
Or you can mail us something if you want.
Yeah, you can always email us at comments@yivvitsandmrbubble.com or just drop us something in the mail, something fun.
That's right.
And you can send it to Yivvits and Mr. Bubble, 168 Tyler Road, Suite, or is it Studio?
Studio.
Studio 137, Red Wing, Minnesota, 55066.
Just send us stuff that's non-flammable and non-poisonous.
Right. I think that's pretty obvious, but yeah.
Well,
in case they're going to send poison.
You never know. I mean, we usually send Obi-Wan to get the stuff for us anyway.
Right.
That's why I'm here.
That's right.
That's what he does for us.
And if it's something top secret, you'd tell everybody, wouldn't you, Obi-Wan?
I didn't say anything.
That one time, remember?
What?
There's that one time we got some letters. You know, you went to the P.O. box, you picked up the letters, they were open, and then I heard from someone else that you told them something.
No.
Yes.
No.
Well, it's 100 episodes have gone by, and it's been a long road. And
you know what's interesting? Go ahead.
Oh, no, please.
Well, we
you
keep
go
walking.
Ahead.
But I was just, you were mentioning that it's like, it took us a little bit more than a year to get to 50. It wasn't exactly a year, but it was like a year and a couple weeks.
Mm-hmm.
It took us 2 years to get the next 50.
Did it really take 2 years?
Yes, even more, because it was July. Yeah, it did. And it's going to take us 4 years to get the next 50 at that pace. So that'll be 2012.
Wow.
By the time we get to 150.
We just better quit counting.
How else would there...
I don't know.
How else would you keep track of them?
We could just give them identifiers, random numbers.
Oh, between 1 and 2 billion?
We'll give them GUIDs.
Okay. What's that? Oh. It's just an observation. But yeah, it's a big picture time. What do you got to say? After the time... because we just went through time.
Well, I'm just not sure how we're going to get them to continue the gardening. I'm not sure how they see that we're going to be able to do that.
Maybe it's like Peter Pan. It's like... Hey, all you listeners, you know, like, why do I bring a Peter Pan reference? But don't you remember, like, wasn't there somewhere they asked the crowd, like, they want Tinkerbell to, like, you know, get her?
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm talking about?
Should we do? Yeah. Do you think she should get her wings or something like
if
that?
If you think so, then they're like, look what's happening now. So maybe, yeah, I get Tinkerbell's the best reference I can come up with. But
exactly.
If you and the crowd want them to get, if you want them to get gardening.
All right, kid.
Yeah, exactly.
No, but look, we traveled time, brother.
We did.
We came back. We're here.
And here we are.
I stupidly didn't buy that book on the way out that said winning lotto numbers between 2008 and 2016. Why did I not buy that?
Don't know. You'd think you would have figured that out from all the other time movies.
So dumb.
There's all those, like, you know, Back to the Future, anything like that. You could have done it.
Right. And you passed, there was that newspaper that said stock tips of the last 50 years.
Exactly.
Killer stock tips.
I don't think it's going to matter when the SWIG takes over, though.
That's true. That'll be nice.
It'll be interesting to see. I mean, I think Virago might make a good leader. That whole thing is weird. How are we going to do that? How are we going to convince?
I don't care.
I don't think we can convince anybody.
The main thing is we got a cake out of it. And that's
true.
And it restored my spirits, too. You got to admit, it was a little crappy before, but...
Yeah, we were kind of in a bad zone, and now...
funk.
It's good now, especially since we got, like, Watt with us.
Oh, you're right, Watt.
He says he likes chocolate cake.
Oh, he is such in luck, yeah.
Yes, the Tauntaun likes frosting.
we can give some cake to the Tauntaun, maybe.
Boba, do you like cake?
Sure.
Okay.
Oh, all right.
How about chocolate?
Yep.
Good.
Oh, he'd
good.
Eat it.
You better ask your dad first, though.
Dad.
You go and ask your dad.
Dad.
Oh, man. We haven't played some of those for a long time.
No.
It's nice to go back on memory lane.
What if Obi-Wan likes cake?
Obi-Wan, do you like cake?
Possibly.
Possibly?
Now,
maybe.
Obi-Wan, remember that one time?
Yes.
Chocolate chip cookies. I said, here's the secret recipe. Don't tell anybody.
I didn't say anything.
Yes, you did.
I didn't say anything.
Oh, I know you did.
Jeez. Oh, you're really on his case today.
I am sorry.
He's also very defensive.
He's a tattler.
What?
You tattle.
What?
You know what I mean, Obi-Wan.
Relax.
All right. Oh, he's using a Jedi mind trick on me. Damn it. I hate it when he does that.
I know. Hey, you know what we should do right now?
What?
Before we go on.
What?
I think we should listen to some of our voicemails that people left for us.
Oh, yummy.
Don't you think?
Yeah, of course.
Are they minty or are they yummy?
These are yummy-licious.
Yummy. Okay, now put that in a Star Wars Galaxies planet name.
Yavin. Yavin-licious. Wait.
Nabalicious.
Nabalicious. Nabalicious.
Yes. Or Roarific.
Roarific. Yep. Dantastic.
Oh, don't spoil them all now. Okay. We want to use some of those.
Roarific? Is that what we said?
No. Nabalicious.
Nabalicious?
Nabalicious.
Hey, guys. This is Greg from Omaha. Just wishing you guys a happy 100th episode. Thanks. And talk to you guys later. Bye.
Hey there, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is PWH from the forums and Pyrochenko from the Flurry Galaxy. It's great meeting you at Fanfare. Want to wish you a happy 100th. Good luck with the upcoming podcast, and hope to speak to you soon.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Mike from SWGblog.net. Congratulations on 100 episodes. Keep up the great work. See ya.
Hi, Yivvits and MrBubble. Zivo here, just wishing you guys a happy 100th podcast. And I'm definitely Alan.
Hi guys, this is Kelly Knox with Sony Online Entertainment, and I was calling to say happy 100. Good job.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble, this is Braden Ayala from Valson. I just wanted to call and drop you guys a quick line. Congratulations on 100 episodes. That's a hell of an achievement. Good job, guys. Keep up the good work.
Hey guys, it's Mr. Happy. I just wanted to wish you guys a happy 100th episode. Sorry, took me a while to call you guys, but hey, I'm calling now. All right, hope to see ya. Hope to. All right, bye. Edit this out. All right, bye.
Hello, Yivvits and MrBubble. I'm Alan. No, actually, I'm Jans Walker, formerly of Starsider, and Egad Zakhni, formerly of the test server. Found your podcast when you first started, and I've been listening ever since, even though I haven't touched SWIG since a couple days before the launch of Jump to Lightspeed. So, on behalf of all of his former players, just wanted to congratulate you on 100 episodes and for figuring out how to say that stupid disclaimer differently every time. I don't know about you, but I think that deserves some kind of reward. A little gold Yivvits statue or something. Anyways, congratulations.
This is Devo wishing you guys a happy 100. It's been a lot of fun listening to you guys, trying to get Jar Jar his pizza. One of these days I'm going to put Palpatino's out of business with Devo's Pizzeria and Ribbon Emporium.
Hey guys, this is Kitty from Falcon, and I just wanted to congratulate you guys on your 100th episode of your podcast. And I've enjoyed the ones that I've listened to so far. Keep up the good work.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. Just calling to wish you a happy 100th podcast. This is 8 years Puepa from the Corbantis Galaxy.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Nameth calling. I just wanted to say herzlichen Glückwunsch für 100 Episoden und alles Gute für die nächsten 100. I'm sure MrBubble can translate. I'm Alan.
Happy 100th episode! It's M-Stock from Austin!
It's Blixta from Austin!
And Calcifer!
Thank you so much for all your support of Star Wars Galaxies! Have a great 100th episode!
Hey there, this is your old buddy Roan Shrine, and I'm calling to say I'm Alan. Thanks, guys. Keep it up. Love you. Sort of. You know what I mean.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble, this is NCAP Jack of the Intrepid Galaxy, calling to wish you a happy 100th. Oh, yeah, I'm Alan. Take care, looking forward to the next 100.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble, have a great 100th episode.
I'm Alan.
Hello, Yivvits and MrBubble, this is Moomint from Belfin, of course. Glad to see you guys make 100 shows. Now for 100 more.
Hi, Yivvits and MrBubble, this is Christopher Field, the new Star Wars Galaxies producer, Dotanuki, on the forums. Just wanted to say happy 100th episode, and I look forward to meeting you guys at Fanfare.
Hi, this is Colonel Sanders from the University of Wookiee Hospital and Clinics, calling for Larry Bubble. This is a reminder that you have a colonoscopy scheduled for September 20th. We'd like to avoid a repeat of the disaster that happened last time, so please, please make sure you do adequate prep and do not bring your own anesthesia. That is illegal. Thank you, and have a good day.
Oh, I just love those voicemails. They're so inspiring.
I love those voicemails.
Mm-hmm. I love when people call our show at what number?
888-900-YAMB.
YAMB, that's our guild.
Yes, we also Yivvits and MrBubble.
We have a guild on Tatooine on Valsin.
Yeah. Valsin. Yes, Medplay here.
And this is like a big, I mean, people will be listening to this. I mean, this episode's going to be on space probes, right?
Oh,
I mean,
yeah.
That's established.
It's been written
out there forever and ever.
It's been written in a gold plate.
Yes.
And it's going to go up in space.
And it's an etching of a Wookiee and a Celestine on the
Yes. and these other characters, they're hearing voices like, you know.
You look absolutely beautiful.
Yeah,
and they're
right.
Thinking, what? Okay. Interesting species.
I tell you, Yivvits, in our game, pets are just... A lot of people, okay.
Tell me, MrBubble.
BMs. Right? When BMs came out.
That doesn't seem possible.
No, but there's all this talk on pets
Wait,
and combat level.
Did levels. You just say when BMs
I
came
know.
Out?
No, there's all this talk on pets and level and combat right. damage and training and tricks. And,
right.
and that's all valid. That's all there, and that's all everybody talked about.
Yep.
People didn't just talk about a pet being a pet. I mean, we probably yeah. talked about it in some sense, but we've noticed this at our parties that more and more people are just mm-hmm. getting them. And what they're doing is they're getting the small, cute ones and turning off the XP gain so they do not grow.
Right.
And the cute, there's just so many cute ones, but the latest one I did was just a bantha. If you just
it
think,
is cute.
Yeah, it's like a little furry dog, and it's yeah. got little horns, and it's so iconic. It looks just like a, it's like everybody's petting it last night. And these people that have played the game forever, they're like, what is that? You know, that's a right. bantha, because everybody in your mind thinks banthas are huge.
Yep.
But I'm telling you, banthas, varactyls, that type of thing, are the cutest damn things you've ever seen. If someone wants a pet, they should have a pet.
They should have one.
Pet. It doesn't matter about the comp level and all that stuff. Just have a pet. They follow you around. You can color them now and make them unique.
Yep.
And if they bite your hand, you can stuff them and put them on.
Yeah, exactly. You can get a different one. Right. Yeah, you know, I really I think that's a missed thing that they missed with the Beastmaster thing. And you always find those kind of things after the fact. But yeah, I mean, there really should be a way for people to have a pet, because you used to be able to just have a pet. In the old days, you could just get a pet and not have to. You couldn't do anything with it.
Yeah.
But it makes no sense that somebody...
You should be able to hatch a pet without a skill point. That's that simple.
If you want to give us a gift for our 100th episode, make it so you can hatch a pet without any skill level.
Right.
Because, look,
right.
What are you giving them at that point? So what? They can hatch a pet, and they can't do anything else with it. They can't make it do tricks.
Right.
And that's fine if you want to do that stuff. You want to make them use expertise because it's tied to the expertise tree.
Right.
But man, just let people have pets.
Yes.
It's so silly not to.
Right. Like, are you saying I can't crack an eggshell? Is that what you're saying? I need a skill point to do that?
Are pretty, you know,
well,
meek,
that's true.
But,
but that leads to so many other things. I mean.
Oh, totally.
Bah.
It's not the skill point even. It's just the fact that you can't just have a pet.
Yeah. And it's a barrier to entry to people that don't get it sometimes.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
But I guarantee there's so many. If you just look at the small pets, I mean, they're so cute.
You should try a Kashikan Bantha.
Oh.
Yes. There's Kashikan Banthas. It might be a cute little pet.
It might be.
Very much.
And they can also lie down, too, with that new, if you pet them.
With the new pet command.
Cutest thing in the world.
Oh, cute.
It gets me so inspired for a droid commander. If they do when they do a droid commander, wink, wink. Hopefully they do that and gardening, right?
Well, a gardening's got to happen, apparently.
Yeah. Oh, I could have my pets running through my garden. I wouldn't have to cut my grass.
Oh, Farnsworth could cut my grass.
Woo-hoo.
I need a Farnsworth in real life.
Oh, my God. That'd be awesome.
I'm going to just go get a goat. Do you want to go halfsies on me with that?
Yeah, exactly. Absolutely. Let's do that.
All right. Can we store it in you got a fenced in yard.
Sure. Perfect.
That's perfect.
Right.
That's awesome, dude. Gosh, people in town have chickens sometimes. I know a guy who had chickens, and he's a great guy, but they wanted the eggs. I mean, it makes sense. Look.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, I'm glad you're here to tell us these things.
Exactly, Han. So what are you doing in the game lately? Are you playing it at all or what?
I haven't been playing too much. It's been kind of a downer in there, but I think things are starting to look up a little bit. It was fun to get in there and see some people that I haven't seen at our last party. Was fun to see them again, and it shows me that people are always continually coming back and stuff.
Yes.
But, you know, when you log in and, what was it, midnight or something, and the cantina texted you, nobody in the Mos Eisley
Our server has problems, no question.
No question. And the thing is, I don't want the server to have a problem. I mean, I want our server to be awesome. Right. I want it to be full and busy because we have great people there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, hopefully they'll do something about that, Mr. Rubble.
Oh, yes.
That'd be nice. But we have to wait and see.
Mm-hmm.
This episode serves as a timepiece or a spot in time.
It's like a time capsule.
Yes.
Bury a pack of gum.
With time travel.
Right. Yeah.
Yes.
We have seen the future. We have brought the cake back.
Maybe you did bury a time capsule. And we should ask Grand Admin about that next time if we ever do see him again.
Right. We could have him bury something in my backyard.
That's exactly right.
I'll get GPS coordinates and say, hey, bury this in my
backyard.
It'd
be a geocaching hunt.
Right. Wait, how would that work? He'd have to go back. No, that wouldn't. Would that work?
Well, he could only go back.
Yeah.
He could only go back a few weeks to when the LHC came online.
Right. But he could get the information and bury it like a week.
That's so complicated.
No. He could just put a book and then bury it in my backyard like a week. Like right now, today.
Let's go dig it up.
It might be there right now. I don't have my GPS coordinates.
Well, let's go dig it up.
Where?
I don't know.
My yard? No, we'll give him the coordinates somehow. He could just tell us stuff about SWIG, though. That'd be great.
He could. Well, I don't think he's going to. Because he doesn't want to reveal too much. You know, it can change the altar. Although they've kind of already messed that rule up.
Well, this cake could alter that. I want this cake, too, by the way, dude. You're teasing me here. You're driving nuts.
Okay, after the next break, we will.
Okay.
All right. Okay. All right. I was going to ask you the same question you asked me. Well, I never finished, I guess. I should finish.
Yeah, okay, go ahead.
I haven't been playing a whole bunch, but... Yeah, I'm getting the itch again, and that we're getting close to publish time, and it'll have new stuff in there. And I think everybody that I know, the main thing, the reason they're not playing is because they think that nobody else is playing. So it's kind of a snowball thing.
Yeah.
For all we know, there's like 50 people that we both know mutually who want to play, and just aren't because they don't think anybody else is playing.
Or they hop to another server.
Or they hop to another server.
I've heard a lot of that.
Yeah.
Thody.
Thody moved?
Yes. What? He's on another server.
You have just ruined my day.
I'm telling you, everybody's moving.
Thody moved?
I heard rumors, yes.
I didn't even hear it. I didn't say goodbye.
Yeah.
Thody. I mean,
just people are doing it in private, so we're putting it on the podcast. We're calling him out. Obi-Wan, wait. I'll tell Obi-Wan, but nobody else. So don't tell anybody. Did you tell anybody, Obi-Wan?
I didn't say anything.
I don't know. We don't have to see what they do. I hate it to hear people go. I just hate it. What I have been doing is a little bit
of... Oh, really?
Well, I got Spore. Mm-hmm. So I've been sporing. Mm-hmm. I've been doing some EQ too.
Okay. Have you played Force Unleashed?
No. Obi-Wan, have you been playing it?
No.
You don't want to be Anakin's secret apprentice?
What?
I think he's avoiding the question.
It'd be a secret. That means you couldn't tell anybody.
I didn't say anything.
Oh, man. How about you, Mr. Robo? What have you been doing lately?
I've actually been playing a lot.
Yeah.
I've been playing on multiple tunes.
How's
and a
that
lot.
Going?
Oh, it's fun. And that's actually, I did try some other servers just to see what's going on. And mm-hmm. I had a lot of good times. They're actually starting. See, on one, I plopped right down in front of Mos Eisley and spent 2 or 3 days just pretending I didn't know anybody.
Right.
And started with 0 credits and I did mission terminals just to get a shuttle ticket and then this and this. And then I got enough levels that I could kill stuff and make. So the point is, after like 10 hours, I had maybe 40,000 credits, you know, that kind of stuff. And it made me really realize, oh.
Good job.
Thank you. That was perfect. But you know, people talk about the olden days. That was the olden days. I mean, it was just those missions. Because I was making 1,300 credits here and there. And we'll see, what server was that? That was Bria. My God. I mean, that's a huge server. Then on another server, I just stayed on the Tansari station.
Okay.
And found out.
What?
It was instanced. I did not know this.
Okay.
I mean, maybe we talked about it. I think we talked about it, wrong or whatever.
I mean, yeah, it is an instance.
Well, here's the thing. I logged on that station, and I had a friend log on the station.
Yeah.
Couldn't find each other.
Yeah.
Just couldn't. It just made no sense to my mind.
It's an instance, yep.
Well, but you can say that now that I told you, but it just made no sense because we could group up. We'd be in a group. We'd be 1,000 meters apart.
Sure.
And just could never get within 1,000 meters.
Where are you?
Yeah, and we thought we were on the wrong station or something. So I was like, okay, I'm looking at this. I see this player, this player, this player. And they're like, nope. And I'm like, okay, I'm in front of this NPC. So am I. But you're still 983 meters away. Step over this way.
That would be confusing.
Yeah, it was. It really was. And then
that would be really confusing.
Then where Han Solo drops you off, there's this little terminal that says it's a friend finder.
Han Solo.
Hey, Han. Yeah, you help me out, Han, because...
All right, kid.
Right there by you, there's a terminal. It looked like a vendor terminal or a bazaar terminal.
Yep.
And anyway, it just said friend finder. You type in your friend's name, and it kind of brings you to the same instance.
Oh, okay. So it transports
then
you.
Then we could see each other.
Gotcha. Yeah. Well, that makes sense.
But I did not know that. It was a very frustrating...
That's
evening.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's really.
Because I didn't. I thought it was all one. I thought it was one zone, but yep. I didn't realize that thing was instanced. Yep. I mean, it's not like it needs to be. There's never like 300 people there for one thing.
There could be for one of our parties. It'd be so fun to try.
True,
that.
True.
They have the beautiful little atrium,
but you can't go there unless you're a new tune.
That's right. I think everybody should make a new tune on a certain server and have a party.
Well,
there
you go. That's true too.
It'd be something to, because then any server could just. It'd be interesting, some way we could pack in the atrium or something like that.
It'd be nice that, you know, it'd be really cool is if they had that thing as a way to socialize with people on other servers.
Oh my God, wouldn't that be nice?
Okay, because let's say you go up there, right?
Right.
But what happens when you go up there is that you go into an instance, right? And you can use that terminal.
Yeah.
For instance, you go to an instance.
Right.
A temporal instance, for example, and you get in there, and then you can use that terminal to find somebody that's also there from another server.
Right.
The only restriction is that you can't obviously trade anything.
Of course.
You know, you can call your pet if you have one, and no combat maybe, but I mean, just, it would be separate from the other one.
Let the big guys figure that out, but I agree, that's cool.
Because then you could go there, because that place has got so many areas to socialize, and it still should be a guild hall. Wouldn't that be an awesome guild hall, the whole thing?
Oh my God, Tansari Station, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
The whole thing. Because, look, there's the atrium. I mean, there's so many. Yeah. Do you realize that Star Wars Galaxies, you used to be able to get factional bases and decorate them?
I did not know this.
Yeah. They turned it off. I don't remember when it was exactly. Maybe somebody can call and correct us if I'm wrong. But I remember when you could decorate stuff. I thought you could.
Hmm.
I'm kind of questioning myself now that I said it. But I do remember them turning something to do with that off. because the stuff could get destroyed.
Oh, okay.
You could get attacked and they'd blow up your stuff.
Oh, right.
But it...
Where's my rare pain?
So we know that those bases can be player-owned. You can still place them, but they're all, like, pre-set.
Oh, okay.
But those things should be... People should be able to use them.
Yeah.
And not... Maybe you have some that are PvP and some that are not PvP. The non-PvP ones, you don't blow up. But you get another building. And, you know, it's kind of frustrating because I know that they don't want to try to reuse that. They'd rather try to make something new. And I'm thinking, you know, after 5 years... People just want some of this stuff that they've seen for 5 years. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we want new stuff too. But look, the fact remains, it's already there. The artwork is there.
The hard work's done.
If you make a new one, sure, you can make something new. And either way, you're going to have to do work because you're going to have to make that other one work again.
Mm-hmm.
But you're still going to have to do that same work to put the new one in.
Yeah,
am I not right?
Yeah, you're correct. You know, the other day at work, I thought about exactly what you said there because I was modifying a Word document for somebody.
Did you make a brand new Word document?
No, here's the thing, though. It was a template, and I could spend my time just opening the document, changing the things, or I could make the new template so I could do it 1,000 times. What do you think Mr. Bubble did?
You made a new template?
No, I did the quicker way. I did what the dev should do. Should we think now they should do? I just did the quick and easy fix and sent it back to him and said, you're done. They should do both. We know they should do both. But
yeah,
their thing is they would rather make a template that they can use 100 times rather than the energy to do that just that first one using the old thing. I think that's what they're trying to tell us.
I don't know. I wish they'd do something.
What's going on?
What? Han, what?
What's up, Han?
Oh, Han wants us to... It's episode 100, right, Han?
All
right,
kid.
Han wants us to have cake.
He wants us to skip all that junk and have cake. Well,
that'll be future
podcast.
Let's
have cake.
Let's have some cake.
Okay, let's get cake. This is good cake, Mr. Bubble.
Not bad.
What does the cake say? What did it say again before we chopped it up?
Happy birthday, Brenlow.
Mm-hmm.
It says, your pals at SOE. Mm-hmm. You can get to our website. We'll put it in the gallery. Mm. Yeah, this cake, it was fun to order this cake. Because the 50th episode, had Darth Vader. You could tell them to put anything on a cake. They'd probably do it. It was a Saturday that I did it, and it was at a grocery store in town. And the funny thing was, I went to the bakery and said, you know, where do I get a cake? And she pointed me to the service desk where they sell stamps and everything else. And I you know, there's people there in line getting lottery tickets and that.
They're sending faxes.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, right, that place. Yep. And I asked about the cake, and the lady's like, oh, yeah, we do cakes. I explained, if I order one now, may I pick it up the next day?
Mm-hmm.
That kind of thing. She's like, ooh, I don't know about that. And I'm like, okay. And then I'll have to call the tomorrow's manager or something like that. And this guy comes over, and he's doing the thing, like, I've mentioned this before in the podcast, but where he doesn't have much power in his life, but he's really happy to have a managerial decision to make, you know? Because
mm-hmm.
he has the fate of my cake in his hands.
Right.
He can say, yes, we'll do that, or no, we can't do that.
Mm-hmm.
And I just wanted to say, yeah, it's like a 3-layer wedding cake. Can you do that by tomorrow? I just want to see what you say. But he got me on one thing. He was kind of, he had the look on his face as if he's questioning it in it. And I just said, well, it's just a simple sheet cake with some lettering. And by then I knew the terms. I go, it's just a quarter size sheet cake.
Oh, you already knew the terms. Your cake.
Okay.
You're really into cake. I mean, that's okay.
Right. He then said, okay, we can do it. Like, it was the biggest decision that, and I don't know if you wanted me to grovel or what, but I'm like, thank you.
Brace yourself.
Exactly. But it was just a weird thing.
And also with our cake, we have our favorite, Diet Pepsi Max. Uh-huh.
You bought a 12-pack yesterday.
And it's already gone.
It's gone. Yep.
Yeah, but we've been at this, now, we should explain how long we've been actually
while I'm eating cake, explain, just ramble a little bit while I'm eating.
Well, the cake, the Tauntaun wants cake.
I got frosting on my fingers. Maybe. I do that to my dog. Ow.
Oh, yeah, don't bite. Jeez. What? Do you want to lick my fingers? Oh, yeah, we've been working the podcast since a week ago. We met one night to talk about our introductionary thing, which was really, I mean, it really did happen, of course, but we had to discuss, you know, what would happen, right?
Yep.
And then we met another night to go over that same thing and record some parts of it, and that actually took two nights to record that stuff. We kind of like to putz around. I think one night we spent 2 hours typing things into text-to-speech websites and having fun with that.
You're so right.
Yeah, so that's how we operate. That's just it. And that's what's fun about it, too, is this the geeking out thing kind of sometimes, right? Well, no, I mean, we had fun that night, I guess. We were going to record some stuff on, I don't know what it was, it's Saturday. It didn't work out. We just did some more planning. Sunday, did the same thing. So here we are Monday, eating cake.
Yum.
So that's that really boring story about the whole the whole thing, how it went through.
We've been so much more laid back lately, and screw it. I mean, we both put 50 hours of a plus in our job. I mean, this is not our job. It's not other things pay the bills, and this is just for fun. So
we were laid back. We were real suave, kind of like,
hello, what have we here? Yeah,
where he's laid back. he's very just
Sorry, am I interrupting anything?
No, do you want some cake over here, Lando? You can have some cake if you like.
Would you join me for a little refreshment?
No, you can join us for some refreshments. Give him some cake, Mr. Bubble.
Here you go. There you go, Lando.
You look absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, he likes that.
He's looking at the cake.
You look absolutely beautiful.
Yep. Does he say it in real life? He must say it all the time.
Oh,
in real
he must.
Life.
He probably says it.
You truly belong here with us.
In my mouth. He's talking to the cake.
Right.
Yeah.
In my belly.
In my belly.
Tonight's such a dilemma, though, with this recording. Tonight is the premiere of Dancing with the Stars and Heroes.
Oh, my gosh.
What would you do?
I wouldn't watch either of them.
Oh, excellent solution. So you could watch them at your own pace in order. I mean,
no, I just wouldn't watch either of them, period.
Oh, you would download them later in the whole box set so you can watch them all.
You know, I never got into Heroes.
No, I'm talking about Dancing with the Stars.
Well, yeah, that, but, you know, that's a whole different thing. Yeah, that's the entertainer dance. I mean, you have to watch that to learn new moves and stuff.
Pretty much, yeah.
Keep your repertoire from getting stale, mostly.
Right on.
All the ladies in the cantina enjoy your exotic dances.
And Muftek and Bosk. I saw Bosk last night.
Yeah, Bosk's always like,
hello, what have we here?
Effie sounded like Lando.
Bosk is like, I got these extra gloves I got to give away somehow.
Mm-hmm, I got these gloves. Mm-hmm. All right, sounds like Virago. Hey, you got these gloves.
The grand admin.
Hey, guys. Well, while we keep eating this cake, why don't we put on some more voicemails?
Indeed.
Hey, guys, this is Pierre and Dr. Bobo from Belson. You guys got me into the game over a year ago, and I just wanted to say thanks. Because without you, I would never have had the great guild and all the good memories I've had in this game. Happy 100th episode. I've been listening since the third one. And just enjoy. Bye.
Hey, guys. This is Sippy from the Tempest server. Like to wish y'all a happy 100th podcast. Love y'all show, even though y'all mess up a lot sometimes. Hope y'all have a good one and keep on podcasting.
Hey, it's Mr. Bubble. This is Naruto from the Valson Galaxy, wishing you a happy 100th episode. And I'm Alan.
Hey, Yivvits Mr. Bubbles. This is Jod from Starfighter, new player senator. Just wanted to say you guys are doing a great job, and just keep up the good work. And it's always nice to tune in and listen to your latest episode. So I look forward to number 100. Congrats, guys. Bye-bye.
Hey, Yivvits Mr. Bubble. This is Locke calling to wish you guys a happy 100th episode. I'll see you guys around. Bye.
Hey, guys, this is Josh from Kansas, and I don't play Star Wars Galaxies, but I absolutely love listening to you. Thank you so much for all your wonderful episodes, all 100 of them, and congratulations on it. Keep it up, guys.
Hi, this is Tim Dryson of Tempest Galaxies. I'm also the creator of the Ask Water Show. I'm just wishing you guys all good luck on your 100 episodes. Thank you.
Hey, if it's Mr. Bubble listeners, this is Brent from VirginWorlds.com.
And this is Darren from CommonSenseGamer.com.
Congratulations to Yivvits Mr. Bubble for reaching 100 shows. I thought that I wanted to do some clever skit or something comedic for this event, but, you know, when you're on Yivvits Mr. Bubble show, you're just not going to top them. So there's not much point in doing so, is there?
No, you can't really top Yivvits Mr. Bubble. Even the name Yivvits and Mr. Bubble, you know, ensues a certain comedic effect. And I've got nothing. I've got nothing. I can't even speak like Yoda right now.
We are just not funny fellows. But
no,
we're super impressed with them doing 100 shows. And also, keeping it going as long as they have. It would be one thing if you did a show every day and did 100 episodes, because that would mean you stay dedicated for 100 days. But these guys have been around longer than really any MMO podcast out there. I can't think of a single one. Can you, that's been around longer?
No. Have you been around longer?
No, not even close. They started, I think, a year before Virgin Worlds did. So, and we only have 130 episodes, but they did over 3 years, I think, now.
Over 3 years. Wow. That's dedication for you, especially for a podcast.
Here's the thing about Yivvits and MrBubble. Not only have they done 100 shows over the course of 3 years, they also have done 100 shows on a single game. Now, obviously, they've got the whole Star Wars thing behind them as well, but I always say that single game shows are doomed the day they start. And that's not a bad thing. It's just saying that, well, eventually those people are going to stop playing those games. So that even goes to show the dedication. It's really easy to do 100 shows like we did on, you know, MMOs, because... well, there's always new MMOs to talk about. Yeah. When you're talking just about one game and you're sticking with that, sticking with that community and being a hub for the community, that's truly impressive.
That is really impressive, especially if you're with it for that long and you provide so much content to the community. It's just, it's an accomplishment for sure. You know, I kind of question going to IKEA every time, but no.
Dude, IKEA rocks. And that is something
IKEA is a store from hell, and you all know it.
Well, that is one thing I want to add. And now we're going on. We don't want to eat up too much of the show here, but I'm going to speak to the listeners. Give us some MrBubble's dedicated listenership right now. I'm talking to the listeners. These guys, they're great guys. And I know that because I've had the opportunity to hang out with them on various occasions. I'm fortunate enough to live within 45 minutes of where they live, so I'm able to attend the meetups. And also, they seem to end up at all of the industry Sony events that I end up at, so that I get to see them there as well. And these guys, they're not just funny on the air. They're really funny in person. They're really a joy to hang out with. And just, you know, great conversationalists in general. So, I mean, don't think that they're faking it or just being podcast personalities. No, they're not. They're for real.
Absolutely. So congratulations, you two, at your 100th episode. Good work all around. And here's to another 100.
All right, guys. Thanks for having us on your show. Sorry we ate up 4 minutes of your precious time. Hope to hear another 100, because you will never run out of Star Wars content.
Congrats, guys.
Oh, man. Those are some great voicemails.
Yes.
Tauntaun, you want some more cake? Okay. What? No, why'd you get enough cake?
Look, come here, Tauntaun. Lick my fingers again. There you go.
Aww, look how cute.
Who likes the frosting on my fingers? That's funny.
I need more Tauntaun sounds. Remember that?
Right.
That's why I loaded that up.
That was right.
I need more Tauntaun sounds, or however that went.
Yep. What was that?
Forgot his name.
Right. Oh, that was funny.
I got a fever. Mm-hmm. That's what it is. And the only cure is more Tauntaun sounds. Your phone's ringing.
What the heck? This one never rings. We only call out on this one.
I know. That's not even a published number.
Hello?
Hi. Hey, this doesn't sound like the answer machine. I was calling to wish you a happy 100th episode. Is this MrBubble?
Maybe. Wait. Yes. Who's this?
I'm Alan.
Yivvits, do you buy that?
Can you say it again just so we can be sure?
I'm Alan.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. No, that's the other number.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh. I thought you guys had some kind of answering machine. What is this?
No, direct line right to our studio.
We turned it off for now.
Oh, I just happened to catch you both in the studio.
Yeah. Well,
I guess that's fortuitous.
We're actually recording the 100th episode as we speak.
Oh, awesome.
Well, thank you so much for calling.
Congratulations, guys. 100 episodes. That's pretty amazing.
That's pretty ridiculous.
It's like 100 of them, yeah. It's ridiculous, yeah. You are Alan Crosby.
I am Alan Crosby.
The real deal. The
real guy.
Global what now?
What is your title?
Senior Director, Global Community Relations.
Wow, that's a long title.
Yeah, every time they have an executive retreat, they add a word to it.
What does it mean exactly? I mean, what do you do?
What exactly would you say you do?
Oh, yeah.
I'm a people person.
Exactly. So you just don't do much of anything then?
No, I really don't. Actually, I sit around and I make random calls to podcasts all day. What do? I actually make sure that all of our community managers have everything they need to do their jobs. And I set our community direction and work in the high end on long-term strategy for community promotion.
And you are Alan, right?
I am Alan.
He is Alan.
Do you ever say it at home, like when you open the door? And
I'm Alan?
Your whole family's there. Do you ever walk in and say, I'm Alan?
No, I don't.
You should.
Like the Here's Johnny line from The Shining. I could make that my little intro.
There you
carry
go.
An axe.
You could do that.
Alan with a big axe saying what?
I'm Alan.
Okay, I want to hear the real Alan and then the recorded. Let's hear Alan. Let's hear you. Can we hear you?
I'm Alan.
I'm Alan.
Well, that's perfect.
That's a good match. If you're not really Alan, you're pretty good at impersonating him. But
God, I listen to your show a lot, so I've gotten a lot of practice.
Oh, good.
I especially like the women that call in and do my voice.
I'm Alan.
Get that. There's one.
I'm Alan.
And then Ross Perot called.
Hi, I'm Alan. on.
He's nice of him to call.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, Alan is a good guy. I'm Alan.
See, now you do a pretty good impression of him, actually. Yeah. Almost better than Ross Perot himself there. Yeah,
that's awesome.
You do the podcast at Sony. You do it with Amy.
Yeah, Amy and I have a lot of fun doing that. We're recording our 47th episode tomorrow.
Wow.
So we're not quite as far along as you, not quite as aged in podcast terms.
Oh, that's you're being Alan.
Mm.
Yeah. Oh,
he's sipping his coffee. He's sipping his coffee.
This is a great double espresso.
No, but that's kind of your bit.
Yeah.
The like, coffee.
You're
stuff.
Into coffee. That's your shtick.
It is our shtick.
Okay.
They've got coffee. We've got Diet Pepsi Max.
Yeah.
Product
Do
placement.
They still make that?
Oh, yeah. It's got a new can even.
Wow. Ooh.
Did you know, Alan, that's an invigorating cola? Not like an invigorating colon or something,
right.
But.
No. Colonic.
Colonic, no. Right. But look, okay, how long have you been with SOE?
I have been here for 8.5 years.
Oh, my gosh. So that was even before Star Wars Galaxies, our game that we
in
play.
In fact, within a couple of weeks of my starting here back in 2000, we signed the contract with LucasArts to do Star Wars Galaxies.
Oh, wow.
We had a big party.
That must have been huge.
It was huge. At the time, you know, SOE back then, or Variant back then, was only under 100 people, actually.
Was that about year 2000, perhaps?
It was in 2000, yeah.
So EverQuest 1, just EverQuest at that time, had only been out a year, maybe?
Uh-huh.
And you signed a contract back then saying you're the guys for a SWIG?
Or we
for
sure a did.
Oh, that must have been huge. You guys, that is just huge.
It was an exciting time. It really
Holy
was.
Holy cow. Were you like giving high fives and fist pumps and all that stuff?
Oh, yeah. And lots of alcohol.
Yeah. Bump chest and that kind of stuff. And EQ, too. You got to be careful when you bump chest.
Really?
Yeah. You might bounce back. You
know? That's true.
You know.
Fist bumps weren't really popular back in 2000.
So then it was a long road, though, from 2000 to 2003. But the whole time, can you tell me, like, the emotions there?
It was exciting. It was a really exciting time. We worked, we acquired a studio out in Austin of folks who had worked on some previous titles for EA and Origin and other companies. And they started working on Star Wars. So here in San Diego, we didn't see too much of the Star Wars work going on, other than the initial community work was being done here in San Diego.
Gotcha.
So most of it was being built there, but there was a lot of excitement here. A lot of us wanted to play the game. And in fact, when the game launched, we didn't get free accounts at that time for Star Wars or free software. So I went out and I bought 5 collector's editions.
The box of tears.
We had a long lunch that day and ran to GameStop and bought a bunch of collector's editions for my family and a couple of friends and ran home and installed and started playing.
God, that's the sweetest.
That's I love that box. I got it right here.
It's a great box. In fact, my wife has had hers signed by several of the cast members so far.
Oh,
she has
so cool.
Jeremy Bullock and... she has like 4 or 5 autographs on there.
That's a good idea. I commonly refer to that as the box of tears.
Yeah. Why tears?
Well, I mean, just, you know, there's so many things in there that, you know, just it's like hopes and dreams and things.
Yeah.
But
that brings up something. I mean, can you just tell the crowd? We had a lot of listeners that ask me all the time in the game, like, we're not in bed with you guys. You guys aren't paying us off or anything.
I'm not, at least.
We got nothing, well, money-wise from you guys. No, I'm just kidding. We're just totally independent, right?
Yeah, you really are. And that's one of the reasons that I support your show and that we've hyped you up on our web pages is you're a totally community-driven show. You do your own thing. You're critical of us when we deserve to be criticized and you know, praise us when you think we're worthy of praise. And you're totally independent, and we respect
like my
you for that.
Yeah. It's like mostly critical, though, but yeah.
But that isn't to say, obviously, that they aren't doing good things now.
They are. In fact, last week I was in Austin. I got to play a little with Hoss. It was exciting. It was fun. They had the whole scene with Echo Base where the rebels cheer when the first transport goes away. It was amazing.
Oh, really?
Star Wars Galaxies, yeah. I mean, it's been doing a lot better now, and the team is doing good stuff. The game's still got some future in it. It's got a bright future. And
it does, and they're continuing to work on it. You know, they just they have Hoth coming up. They have some other fun things going in. The Halloween events, I don't know if you've heard about those. They have great Halloween, which the Star Wars team has never put in Halloween events before, so this is kind of new and fun.
Right.
I got to see those last week, and that was exciting. Yeah. A little frightening.
No, that they talked about that at Fanfare, and it looks pretty cool. I mean, they didn't show us anything, but it sounds fun.
Yeah, you'll get to see it really soon here.
Mr. Bubble, do you have anything else you want to ask that's been really just on your mind about Alan?
Well, many things, but no.
I'm Alan.
Oh, sure. Hey, Alan, what's the most sensual of the SWIG species?
Most sensual?
Yeah.
Rhodium.
Oh,
okay. Really?
Interesting. Noting that. Okay.
Twi'leks, actually, I think, are the most. The Leku, they do it for me.
Yeah.
The Leku?
They're very sensitive.
Yeah. Not Solistons. Yes. They don't do much for me.
They're dead last, probably.
Yeah, they look like they have 16 chins. It just doesn't work. Yeah.
You'd go with a Trandoshan before a Solistan? Is that what
I'm
saying?
Yeah, yes.
No, I wanted to explain to people also why there's also another reason we had you on this one. It's just early on in the process, you were especially open to us way back. I think that was late 2006,
Something like that, yeah.
I was out there in San Diego visiting a friend. You're like, come on by. No, you're like, come on by. Or
whatever you say.
Right.
That's what he said to you.
Yeah, and that just
opened
our eyes to some other directions and just stuff we could have done rather than just being, you know, a little rinky dink.
Well, I think it was mainly more that it showed that you're not just all evil, you know.
Well, we're not. We're mostly evil.
Yeah.
We're not all evil.
Well, right. No, I mean, because, you know, tensions are high at that point in the game and, you know, and it was nice to actually just get to meet some people.
Oh, it was great to talk to you guys and to bring MrBubble in and show him the studio here. And there always had been a perception that we were kind of aloof about our customers and that there was a little bit of evilness to us, especially during that time. And I wanted you two to know that we were open to criticism when it's constructive criticism, when it's not just, you know, ranting about how much we suck. And
because that's established.
Yeah, exactly. I'd been listening to your podcast, and it was exciting to meet you. Actually, as a little fanboyish.
That's okay. That's but so yeah, there is a reason to that, and everybody else answers to you anyway, so we can't talk to them. They have to go through you, so that's why we went to you, right? You're like the top dog to all those other people we know, and all the other red names in the community, right? Aren't you?
Yes, they do work for me, but they're approachable and they're good people. You know, Valara is a lot of fun, and I believe she's helped or talked with you guys a few times.
Yes.
And promoted your podcast a few times.
Very much.
Yeah. So of the community side, you're the ultimate red name. Would that make sense?
I guess that's one way to put it, but really in a way, I'm actually the biggest lackey because my position exists solely to take care of them and make sure they have what they need.
Oh, I see. They do the heavy lifting. That's what I always say about you. It's that kind of thing.
Yeah.
They're the ones, they're on the floor. They're doing it.
That's right.
Yeah, gotcha.
You're like a facilitator.
Yes, that's a good way to put it.
Okay. You're one of those people in life that if you're not there, people notice. But if you're doing your job 100%, nobody notices.
Yeah.
Oh. That's yes, exactly. Unless you're emceeing an event, and then we all notice.
Oh, right. Of course.
Because we hear you singing and...
Yeah, you know. right.
Please don't bring up the singing.
Oh, yeah. The singing.
I'm Alan.
Thank you. We'll use that later on, maybe.
I figured you might.
But
and then at the public events, as you mentioned, I am out front. But for day-to-day, I'm behind the scenes.
Yeah.
So that's why you don't see me on the forums much, because I don't want to step on their toes. That's their gig.
Well, you have a lot of forums you have to visit.
Yes.
Yeah, and that's right. We keep making this sound like it's just SWIG, but my God, I mean, you're...
Oh, yeah, you get EQ and
Matrix.
EQ2 and Matrix. Well, Matrix isn't a big deal. I mean, Matrix that's like three alone. People. So.
That's probably like 50% of his day.
Matrix is a very big deal to the Matrix players.
Oh, of course it is.
Of course, yeah.
Yes. All three of them.
You can tell this guy's community. Listen to that answer. Yeah, Matrix is a very big deal to the Matrix players. That's awesome.
No, but I mean, I understand that. Because it's SWIG to us, and the Matrix players are probably... can't stand SWIG, so
he's gonna call the Matrix podcast next.
Actually, a lot of them were cross players. A lot of the Matrix players came from Star Wars Galaxies after that fateful day.
Interesting. I've never played the Matrix online, so I really, really can't say anything about it.
Yeah,
but I can say things about Planetside.
Do you like
how long have you had Planetside? But I'm just curious.
Planetside launched, I believe, just shortly before SWIG, Star Wars Galaxies.
And that's still going. I mean, you have not had a game close, have you?
Not yet, no.
Oh, that's an interesting statistic. That's really interesting. Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not. No MMOs? Actually, Sony Online, when it was up in L.A. before it merged with Varant, actually shut down a couple of their casual games, but that was before the Varant SOE merger, and SOE became what it is today, and took over EverQuest and started making MMOs. And yeah, we have not shut down a game yet.
Right. yet. I love that.
Yeah, so you got to keep all the options open.
It's like a boss saying, we've never fired anybody yet.
Yeah. But after this podcast.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, exactly. Hopefully it's not our fault.
And we understand SWIG is entirely different because of LucasArts. Do you have contracts like that with other MMOs?
Matrix, I would think.
Matrix also is a licensed product. Yeah, so with the Matrix, we deal with Warner Brothers.
Okay. Yeah.
And those add additional challenges and restrictions and things we can and can't do.
So Warner Brothers could say, no more Matrix, and then pull the plug on Matrix. They would have that power.
Potentially, yeah. It is their license. It is their IP.
Yep.
But it's like, I think you may, I don't know, maybe it was you that said it in a forum or something, but you know, as long as the game's making money and there's subscribers there and it's not a net negative for you guys, what's the reason to pull it? So
that's true. I mean, why would any company want to throw away money? As much as people want to associate noble concepts like free games and all that to companies, we exist, companies exist to make money. And as long as the game is making money, mm-hmm. why shut it down?
Alan, you won't understand it, but thanks for the cake.
Oh,
it'll make
God.
Sense
what
later.
Did you do?
No, nothing.
Well, anyway, what else you got?
Not a big deal.
Hey, you're welcome for the cake. I'm glad to help.
You have no idea.
Just out of curiosity.
Yeah.
Chocolate or vanilla?
I actually like a white cake.
A white cake. Okay. Yeah. So vanilla or almond or something.
Yeah.
I suppose.
Okay. And I'm especially fond of cream cheese frosting.
I think someday you might like chocolate cake with buttercream frosting.
Yeah.
buttercream frosting is good.
Yeah.
I actually prefer pie over cake, though. I don't know if you've heard those.
Oh.
I've heard the pie. Yeah.
Maybe it'll change someday, though. Yeah.
Be a big pie shortage of, you know.
You never know.
2020 or something.
Yeah. I love it.
How did you get your name, Branlow Bixie Bopper?
Oh, okay. That's I had been invited to come down and work in customer service, and on the drive down, that long 24-hour drive from Seattle to San Diego in a U-Haul, I actually started thinking of what I wanted my name to be, and I wanted to not be, I didn't want to try and be intimidating, and I didn't want to try and dominate players. I wanted to be fun and playful, so I thought, well, I'll be a halfling. Well, what's a good halfling name?
And halfling is what now? Just for people that remember, this is like Star Wars Galaxies people.
In EverQuest, a halfling is kind of like a hobbit in Lord of the Rings.
Okay.
They're short and sort of dwarf-like, but not with beards. And they're usually very jolly folk who enjoy pies and cake.
Ooh.
And so I decided just the name Brenlow just came out of nowhere. And then as far as my last name, Bixie Bopper, which some days I wish I hadn't chosen, I was fond of killing Bixies. I would run through Rivervale, which is the town that halflings start in EverQuest originally, and kill Bixies, which are these bee-like creatures. In fact, the original ones look like John Belushi from Saturday Night Live wearing the bee suit, if you remember that old
thing. Right. Yep.
And I would kill them, so I was the Bixie Bopper, and of course, many people on the forums and in the communities have taken that in a different direction.
Right.
And
I don't know what that is, but, you know.
And it got even worse in EverQuest, too, when the Bixies actually became female and were somewhat
voluptuous. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
We're thinking the same word there. You know, I play a little bit of EQ too as well. So when I get mad at something like targeting in Star Wars Galaxies, I go and play EQ too.
You mad at targeting? Never.
Yeah.
Yeah. The textures are fixed, but thank you. You know.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, no. But no, really.
I'm Alan.
No, but that's a cool thing. I mean, everybody's got a story behind their name, and except Mr. Bubble. I mean, well, his is the best, I think.
I actually do.
I was taking a bath.
Like, big deal, yeah.
Taking a bath.
My shower was broken in real life.
Yes, exactly. Is there anything you want to ask us?
Why do you guys keep doing this?
We ask ourselves that every time we meet, actually.
Yeah.
But it's really one of the things that keeps us playing, for one thing. Because, you know, we're on a light server kind of right now, and it sucks to see people going and stuff. And
I think he's looking for a deeper answer, though.
I'm getting there.
God, Mr. Bubble.
Exactly. No, it's just fun to sit down and banter after a long, crappy day at work about Star Wars and Star Wars Galaxies. And, you know, we kind of just self-analyze all the stuff that's happening. And we don't sit and go over news items and things like that very much anymore like we used to. You know, we've started to kind of talk more with players again. Now we've got better recording stuff for phones and because we like to hear what they have to think about stuff.
A question for you, Alan. Like, what should we do? We have this new equipment and everything. We have the enthusiasm and the captive audience. If what we do is beneficial, what can we do more of that helps the bottom line the most? Your goal is to make money. Our goal is to get more players to play with and hang out with and all that stuff.
Well, I really think that what you're doing is in that direction. Now, adding more player interaction, highlighting the community, because that's really, in my opinion, what keeps you two going, is you're a part of the community and you respond to that community and you like being a part of that community while you have your parties every week. And, you know, you are hoping to grow that community, and that's a great thing. And I think that fun and entertainment adds to that. People listen to your podcast who don't even play the game, but through listening to you, they may start playing the game because they hear you talk about something that's intriguing.
All right.
But also bringing on those folks from the community and highlighting them and showing off other people who play Star Wars or other people who may potentially play Star Wars now that you have all this new tech and that you can have phone calls and build those bonds. That Star Wars community is already a very tight-knit community. There are great folks, very passionate, and they love that game and they love that universe. And you guys can just help build on that. And you have been for years now.
Yeah, I mean, because we do hear from people, and they'll say, I wasn't going to give it another try, but I've been listening to your show, and God, you know, just I really want to see that thing, you know, this thing we saw or whatever. And it's nice to hear that just because it brings people back. You get money out of it, but we get something probably more. I mean, from
I don't personally.
Well,
see
okay. You, don't you get a cut? I thought Sven gave you. Here's your cut this week, Alan.
Gosh, thanks, John. No, but you know, marketing is great, and I do hear a lot of Star Wars players and in all of our games go, why isn't there more marketing? Well, what you two do is very valuable and more authentic than any marketing campaign, and people respond to that much better than they do to an ad in a magazine or a stand-up in a store, because you two are actually players. You're talking about your experiences, and you're giving real insight into the game that they're not going to necessarily get from seeing a box flash.
Unless they're into PvP, and then we just don't talk about it. So,
right.
But, you know, we never say we're not selective.
Right. As long as it's dancing or making beasts, we got you covered. the interest level, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it really comes down to people, I guess, and
we've always
in the
said
game.
That, yep.
So, and like we just saw people coming back last night's party, that we haven't seen for a long time.
Awesome!
That's just the best thing ever. When
that's
that.
The beauty of these games. We can make these great worlds where people go and have fun, but ultimately it comes down to the people, and it's the friends you make, it's the people you hang out with, it's the people who set the tone for the forums or for your server, and that's what brings folks back.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Right. It's just a great place to socialize. You know, it's
and dance with
fun.
Ribbons.
And dance. Right.
Yeah. Purple ribbons.
Yeah. I'm on
you
a
get
shape,
to wear
my
hot
money.
Pants, which you can't do in Minnesota in real life.
No, I can't. I'm a Wookiee. I can't wear anything hardly.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, Wookiees are very limited
big
in their attire.
We are limited. It's like ridiculous.
Yeah, what do you want, Chewbacca in a tuxedo?
No, but I mean, Chewbacca at least should get like
what?
He should at least get equal stats and stuff.
Right. I just don't want to
see
Wookiees.
A Wookiee doing that whole scene from Young Frankenstein. With
oh, right. I'm with you. You are old, man.
Yeah, I am.
You probably old ladies rock bands, right?
I'm Alan.
What's like your top? One of your favorite top three groups.
Top three groups?
Yeah.
Oh, you're setting me up here.
Yeah, I am. Yeah. Starts with a D.
Stalker.
D.
Let's see.
I ran across it by chance, to be honest with you.
I do like Depeche Mode.
There you
A lot of their older stuff.
Delicious.
I like
apple pie. And, Depeche Mode. Okay.
Depeche Mode, yes.
Okay.
Not Alamode.
Okay.
I do like Alamode as well.
I like that too, actually.
Pie Depeche Mode.
One of my favorite things is a nice piece of apple pie with some vanilla ice cream on top.
Wow. Yum. Into Depeche Mode.
What about the cake, though? Chocolate? No?
Chocolate, or actually with cake, you know, it's more about the filling and the frosting for me than it is the cake.
All about the filling. I never thought about it that way. Anything else you want to say?
I want to say thank you two, for putting on this show and for doing it so well for so many years. 100 episodes is a great thing. Congratulations.
Well, thank you. We appreciate all your help and all your assistance and all the help your team gives us, too.
Yeah.
Let's not forget them.
Alan, what can I say? Thanks for calling us out of the blue. What are the incredible odds that we were actually recording this when you called?
But so strange it lined up like that.
Sometimes it just is meant to be. So.
Oh, no problem, guys.
Thank you, Alan. Wow, what a surprise.
Oh, Alan, if he only had an idea.
I don't think he... I hope he didn't catch on anything.
No.
Jeez. Oh, my God. You know what could happen?
What
if future Alan gets mad and wants to get his cake back?
Oh, my God. Wait a minute.
We already ate it.
What if he put some in it?
Oh, my God.
Maybe there's a message in the cage. We could dig into it. He's not going to know. That'll
be
like
you're right.
50 years from now.
Let's just hope.
Right.
Let's just hope.
My bathroom's right over there if you need it.
Okay. All right. Yeah,
maybe Dr. Keller can help you out.
My stomach will start sounding like.
The only way this is work, okay, we got to keep this secret. So, Obi-Wan, don't tell anybody like you did last time.
I didn't say anything.
Sorry. Do you want Obi-Wan? Did he get cake? Give him some cake, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Very impressive.
It is.
Yeah,
it's not too bad.
Not too bad for a grocery store.
No,
I don't think so.
No. Very good. Jar Jar, did you get any cake? Did we give Jar Jar cake?
Obi-Wan's got some frosting.
Oh, Obi-Wan.
Can you send over the tauntaun?
Yeah, hold on a second here. Wow, look at him go.
Oh, yeah, he's cleaning that beard.
Good job. Thank you.
Lisa said thank you.
I can't believe a tauntaun just licked Obi-Wan's beard clean of frosting.
Oh, man.
I love that.
He's right. Very impressive.
Don't tell anybody.
I didn't say anything.
I know, but that one time you did. I mean, I know. You know, with Captain Typho.
Captain Typho has more than enough men downstairs.
Well, that's interesting.
Okay, so Sony called us. I want to call one of our favorite people, too, sometime.
Well, yeah, thanks, Alan, for calling. That was really nice of you. We appreciate it. Well, maybe we should listen to one more voicemail set before we call somebody else.
Yes, we should.
While we do that, Owen can go try to find Luke.
Luke!
Luke!
Luke! Have you seen Luke this morning?
He never finds Luke.
Can you speak bocce?
Oh, no, I don't. Sorry. Oh.
Luke! 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 Luke!
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Evangelion off the website. I just like to call you guys and say happy 100th anniversary, and I hope you guys continue on making great podcasts.
Hey there, greetings, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Pex from the SOE community team, and I was calling to congratulate you guys on a happy 100th episode. So I'll give you a call back around episode 1000 for another voice message. So you've got a lot of work ahead of you, so get that Wookiee labor force motivated. Congratulations, and may the force be with you. And, oh yeah, I'm Alan. Bye.
Hey, guys. This is Crazy Cody from the Brie Galaxy. I was just calling to tell you guys happy 100th episode. You guys are awesome. And, by the way, I'm Alan.
Hey guys, how's it going? This is Jake Neri. Congratulations on your 100th episode. You know, your dedication is admirable, and I think all of us here at LucasArts really appreciate your continued support of Star Wars Galaxies. So, thanks very much, and again, congratulations. Hope you guys celebrate in style.
Hot Wookiee loving! Yeah, this is Garibaldi from Flurry Server, and I wanted to tell you guys that you got me back into Star Wars Galaxies, and I'll never forgive you for it. And congratulations on your 100th podcast. I've been loving your show since I found it. Take care. Bye.
Hey, guys. It's Subcap. I just wanted to wish you a happy 100th podcast. How many podcasts is that in Wookiees? I'm just kind of curious. Much slobbering to you, MrBubble, and may you have many calms. Catch you guys later.
Hi, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Nathan from Kettamore. I just wanted to give you guys congratulations on hitting 100 episodes. I'll be sending a package your way with a very nice surprise for you guys. See ya.
Hello, I am a Speedo Dancing Zabrak from the Dalsin Galaxy. You know me as Balls. I wanted to congratulate Yivvits and MrBubble on their 100th episode. In honor of that, I have a special guest to wish you luck on your next 100 episodes.
I'm Alan.
Hi, this is Swiftrim from the Valson Galaxy. I'm calling to congratulate Yivvits and MrBubble for reaching their 100th episode. Yay! And to add to the collection, I'm Alan. Congrats, guys.
Hi, I'm Alan, and I wanted to wish you congratulations on your 100th podcast, and I'm going to get you back for all of the teasing you've given me over the years. Oh, yes, I am.
We keep finding all those people we forget to give cake to, MrBubble.
Yes.
You didn't give any to Newt.
Oh, Newt. Hey, Newt.
What?
Do you want some cake?
I don't know.
Oh, well, here, try
some. Just give it to him.
Yeah,
give him some cake.
Here's a plate.
Wow, I didn't know pneumonians could eat that fast.
Look at that.
Again.
More cake?
Oh, man. Okay, here we go.
Oh, God, not
another,
this again.
Another piece of cake.
Again.
Oh, really? I'll make the piece smaller. Here you go.
Make it tiny.
Yeah, here's a tiny piece of cake.
Is that?
Well, that's a valid-sized piece of cake. Just eat it.
Again.
Okay.
Again.
Oh, really?
Does your wife know that you're having all those calories?
Well, no.
Ah, see?
Uh-huh. Okay.
Are you supposed to be eating that much cake?
Well, no.
Well, then that's enough.
Yeah, you're going to end up like your little your shipmates. They're like, the ventilation shaft.
Let's call one of our favorite people. Do you want to call him?
Who?
Let's call Two-Tone.
He's going to dial for us. Watts dialing.
Oh, that does sound like a phone, doesn't it?
He's dialing. Yep. Thank you. Two-Tone?
Is this Two-Tone?
Hey, where have you guys been?
What do you mean?
We've been around. You know, we've been keeping busy.
Do you
busy.
Know who this is, Two-Tone? I'm MrBubble.
And I'm Yivvits. This is a podcast about...
I've been trying to call you for, what, days, weeks?
Really?
Why? Well...
We didn't know you were going to call. That's an unexpected pleasure. I kind of... I appreciate that you were going to call.
You can call us anytime, buddy.
Well, it's awfully hard to get hold of you sometimes. actually.
Yeah.
Well, it can be. I'm sorry if you haven't been able to get a hold of us. I hope it wasn't like any really good juicy news from the cantina or something.
Oh, with always all kinds of things floating around.
Really?
Concerning you guys? Well, let's just say everybody loves the show.
Oh, well, that's good. Sweet. That's always good to know. That's always good to know.
Well, right now we're recording right in the middle of recording our 100th episode.
Mm-hmm.
And we called somebody from Sony, influential, mm-hmm. a VIP.
Oh, yeah.
And now we're calling a player who we think is a VIP and influential and affected our path down the stream here. And we put them all the possible ones in a jar and pulled out your name. No, there's only Two-Tone. There's only Two-Tone. All right. I'm emphatic about this. So we got, and I'm so glad we got you. You're hard to get as well, my friend. So.
100, huh?
Yes. 100.
Yes.
Last time we spoke to you, we were doing 50.
Right, that's right.
And I had to pop off and say that I'd show up again on the 100th episode,
yes.
didn't I?
Yes,
you did.
How unfortunate for you.
A promise is a promise.
Well, guys, I couldn't be more proud that you guys made it to 100.
Okay.
Well, thank you.
He's like our daddy.
I know. His daddy Two-Tone.
He's... I'm proud of you raking the leaves, Mr. Bubble. You did a good job.
You never heard that.
Pat on
come
the head.
On.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
I never did.
That's true. No, but seriously, you frequently go to a lot of the parties we hold, and everybody gets to know you. You have a strong role-playing character. Two-Tone has a very strong set of rules, how you play the game.
Well, it's really the first game I've ever tried to play, so I didn't really know the rules, so I just sort of made them up, and that's how we turned out.
Do you want to tell people a few of the things that you do just to make Two-Tone Two-Tone?
Yeah, like if they don't know Two-Tone and they met him at a party, what would they find without giving away too many secrets, right. Of course?
If Saipam is the party decorator, I'm always going to go and check the structures. No offense, but some of that stuff is death-defying.
That's true.
And you're talking this the lack of railings and things like that.
Oh, yeah, it's positively dangerous.
Okay. Yeah, you're always there to make sure it's up to code.
Yes.
Yeah, and informed me that they'd run the actuarials and it was actually cheaper to pay for any accidental deaths than it all the hand railings. I get that. It's a fiscal decision.
Yeah, we cranked
that's
it through.
Scary.
Like the cloning fees, you're absolutely right. Cloning fees are less than railings.
Wow.
Yeah.
Something's not right about that.
I forgot that shtick, but we did that at a party. I remember that now. That was funny.
I wasn't there for that one. That's funny.
Yeah, and that makes sense though, dude, doesn't it? It's like we can put in a railing, which costs, 2,000 credits, or we can clone them for 1,800. But that's just an example. I mean, you're always there with that kind of stuff.
Two-Tone has very good emotes.
Yes.
Well, let's just say they come from an economy of words.
I don't always know all the words, but they're good. They're funny.
You walk everywhere a lot of times, right?
Oh,
or
always,
beast.
Yeah.
Really?
Do
you take shuttles?
Like me doesn't want to move through a crowd too fast. Some of those, especially Bothans and the occasional Ewok, you just don't see them down there.
No, they're pretty small. I mean, you're already a Wookiee, so you're already pretty big. I don't know if we've mentioned, maybe Two-Tone is a Wookiee. What are you now, by the way? Are you Imperial or Rebel or something in between?
You know, as the story goes, I was an Imperial Wookiee, and you can send all your comments about that to YivvitsandBubble.com. But I was a general and woke up one morning and I wasn't, and I found out what it was going to take for me to become a general again, and I decided that maybe it was time I left my service.
Mm.
Yeah.
So you were a general once, huh, Two-Tone?
I was, and I consider myself lucky to have held the rank considering the Empire.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, good point.
Their policy towards Wookiees has not been amicable, really. We were talking about when we first kind of started doing this. When did you, how did you find us?
Great question.
Back in the day, how did we meet?
Yeah, how did you find us?
Be part of a guild called Gigahertz.
GHZ.
One of our functions was to sort of hang out in the common areas and, at the time when the traffic was high, there were lots of folks running around asking lots of questions that, maybe you might find on the boards, but if you hadn't been to the boards, you wouldn't know. Simple stuff, mm-hmm. more difficult stuff, whatever. We just tried to help out.
Mm-hmm.
Gosh, I wasn't actually a member of Gigahertz for a while, but I think while I was entertaining the notion, I met Mr. Bubble. We did some pilot stuff back in the day,
mm-hmm.
walked me through a couple of Corvette runs till I kind of got the hang of it, and then he said, oh, I have to introduce you to a friend of mine. His name is Yivvits, and around the corner came probably the third Wookiee I'd ever had a direct conversation with.
Really? I didn't know this part of the story. Yeah. Interesting. Why so few? That's a popular species. Is it not in the game, you think?
It was, but I guess early on, everyone wanted the benefits of armor. And, because of innate stats that were, we sort of had to take a different path. If you were a Wookiee, there wasn't precious little you could wear to begin with. If you needed the uber PBPers, not very many of them were going with the innate red line.
Right.
No. It's the plight of our species, really. But was that before the podcast, or?
Oh, yes, definitely.
I didn't remember that there was time before podcast. So you already kind of knew Mr. Bubble then, and me a little bit. You heard about the podcast thing?
Well, I'd heard about the podcast directly from Mr. Bubble, and I was like, I know that word, but I've not actually experienced it yet. Let's go find out what that's about.
Yeah, you can't overlook that, because there just weren't many out there yet. I mean, they definitely were out there pre-iTunes, but they just weren't easily accessible. You know?
Right. They had a few corporates and then, you know, a few super undergrounds and nothing really in between.
Wow. Right.
We bridged the gap.
Well, for me, you did, because I, you know, like I said, I'd heard the term. I knew what it represented, but you guys are the first subscription I ever pulled.
There you go. Oh, honored. And you listened to the first 5 or 6 or 7, and probably are cringing every time we said something with a P or a B as in boy or something like that, right?
Ah, yes, the good old days.
Say it again. What's the word? What did you introduce us to? What component?
The magic of pop filters.
Right.
Yay!
Pop filters. And believe it or not, people still don't do them sometimes. I've heard some.
No, I know.
Usually I listen to episode ones and of other podcasts, and a lot of times they do not have pop filters.
A lot of people rely too heavily on the little sort of nose cone wind.
Yeah, that doesn't do anything. Yeah, and it's so cheap. I mean, the first ones we had were like little round wooden knitting things.
You're
going to
kill me. Can I try it without a pop filter once? You're going to kill me. Here we go. This is before two-tone. Pop. Oh, okay, you can totally hear it.
Yeah, of course.
Pop filter. And then...
And never do that again.
And after two-tone, pop filter. I mean, brilliant.
Now, what you should have done to be funny was just do it again, like
without the filter the second time. Yeah,
exactly.
See how good it sounds. Thank you, dude. Yeah. No, but that was, that was a biggie. But you were, because you're in the. If people can't tell by your tech terms you're throwing around, is you're in the biz of some of this equipment, right? So,
I think my degree says audio engineer.
There you go.
He knows something about
there
it.
You go.
I don't get called. Much.
So we really
button
appreciate
flipper
that.
And knob twister, that'll work.
Really? That's actually a little more, I think that's a better title. That's what I'd want.
And occasionally coffee getting person.
We need one of those.
I know. Yeah.
They could go get us pop right now, or soda. What was I saying? The first one were like these knitting circle things and then pantyhose.
Right. And whose?
Oh, my mother's
of
pantyhose.
Course. Of yes. course.
You guys weren't sure you knew where you could just run right out and pick one out before you recorded. So I said, okay, you know, go to Hobby Lobby and pick up the following things.
So Two-Tone has helped us a lot through the years, and he's helped me pick out hardware for recording stuff and helped me pick out some portable recording stuff recently that turned out to be a great pick, of course.
You know, over the past several years, we've discussed several technical aspects, you know, starting, I guess, with homemade pop filters and why you need them. And, we moved on to, I remember talking about spatial placement and recording in stereo, and we talked a lot about MIDI controllers once. You actually taught me more about that than I taught you. And I even recall at one point we had a series of emails about software discussions that just got way over my head fast. I'm kind of an analog guy in a digital world, but it should be pointed out that you two and your skill sets have, you far exceeded any of my humbly submitted advice.
Hey, Two-Tone? I'm an analog man, too. I just realized that. So thanks for bringing that term into my life. I love that term.
Well, the grand admin knows that if you guys didn't do this, there'd be a lot of folks that wouldn't be playing. So.
What?
I'm just saying, your skill set has far exceeded
grand
any
admin?
Of my assistants. Did he say grand admin?
He couldn't possibly know what that
I've been a happy spectator ever since then.
So, Two-Tone, officially, how long have you been playing?
My get vet is 1893, so not the highest
year.
Number out there, but been around a little while.
Hey, it's long enough to get that floating chair.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Yes.
Yeah, that thing climbs hills like a sunrise.
The size-reducing chair.
The two-tone sunrise.
What do you have? What about our future on the podcast? What do you think with this thing? What should we do?
Just
be honest.
Absolutely essential that you continue.
We weren't so sure. But.
I meant kind of technically, but you're saying like just in general, do the whole thing?
The whole thing, yes, absolutely. And
really?
Please continue to do it for everyone's sake. Just saying, in a very real and legally binding sense.
Well, we just got back. I don't get it. He would have no way of knowing we were talking or bickering about that.
Well, we'll deal with it later.
Okay.
Well, yeah, we'll appreciate that. Thank you. It's fun. It'll be fun again when they have some more stuff for us to talk about. You know, we'll have to help try to support ideas that are worthy of being supported.
Like gardening. I'm all for gardening. We don't talk about that enough, Yivvits.
No, we don't.
I know it's our 100th episode show, but, you know.
We need the gardening system. It is very important. And
would that be something that would interest you, Two-Tone, is gardening?
Oh, absolutely. I've been intrigued since, let's just say the more you read up on it, the more you study, the more important it's going to be to, well, my gameplay and probably yours.
Wookiees are good gardeners.
It'd be great.
I understand.
I believe that. So gardening would be fun because then in the game, I won't cut my grass either. You know what I mean? It's like I can have another place where I don't want to cut my grass now.
Me too.
Yeah.
Well, just send Farnsworth over. He'll take care of it.
Oh, he'll do that. Creatures could do that.
Yes.
What do they call that?
Kitty lawyer could do it, and yeah. Farnsworth. We're skipping around, but that's us. That's what we do. But one thing I remember about Two-Tone the most is he was always a master creature handler.
Of course. Yes.
Yes.
And
bad days. The thing about the new system is that it is just not me. I was the wilderness guy poking things with a stick.
Yeah, you know, that's something that doesn't cater to when they have done that. That's a really good observation, actually. That's something that they lost and they didn't regain yet, is that ability to go out and not have to sit in front of your crafting station.
Exactly.
But still have something fun, because that's how the creature handler was. You actually had to be out there doing things.
You know, it's just Two-Tone's not a lab coat kind of guy.
Mm. Yeah, that's what it is. And that, I mean, that's what everything is. There isn't anything anymore that's very nature-based. That's where gardening should come in.
They really should do gardening.
I was just about to bring that up.
But that's seriously, though. That's one other reason why something like Ranger would be nice again. Something that relies on the world in the game rather than the resources and the, you know, all that crap. It's a whole different mechanic.
I'm really looking forward to gardening for the future.
You really? Keep coming back to that. Like, okay, we get it. I mean,
you know, everybody wants a little place to call their own and a little space in that place that they can do what they want to with. And this sounds like that.
All we can do is kind of try to keep working for it. And
well, historically speaking, you have a record of having either guessed correctly or perhaps influenced some decisions. It's hard to tell. So keep plugging away.
I'm sure
that.
It's all been dumb luck.
Yeah.
Well, where do you see Star Wars Galaxies going in the next few years?
Difficult to see, it is. Well, speaking pragmatically, eventually all games have to sunset. If there's an online component, either the technology outpaces it and the clientele withers away, or the finances wither away first. So until that day, I think we're looking at a maintained game, guys. I mean, it doesn't look like they're sunsetting yet. They're going to keep pumping resources into it, and I hear Hoth is getting a lot of buzz, and I hear things are on the table after that, especially with gardening come along. I don't want to stress it too much, but then again, I'm not sure you can.
If Two-Tone Yivvits is into gardening, just think of just all the other people that must
all the
be
other
into
people
it
are into it. Yeah,
are we into it? We don't know. They have to explore this, and I think you guys are just the ones to see that they do that.
I'm picturing Yivvits with a water can watering his little daisies in the garden.
I would not have daisies. I would have chrysanthemums.
Oh, right, okay.
Because you couldn't say it.
I could not.
Let's hear it.
What is it? How do you say it?
Chrysanthemum. Can you say it, Two-Tone?
Chrysanthemum?
Yes, see, there you go.
Synthesizer.
Synthesizer.
The sink is made of zinc.
How have we adversely or inversely or whatever, reversely, affected your Star Wars Galaxies experience in any way?
Good question.
The honest answer is that I probably would have moved on to something else ages ago if it hadn't been for Yivvits and MrBubble.
Oh, interesting. I hear that more than you may think. Yeah, I hear that a lot, actually.
Despite all the things that we talk about that are wrong with it, it's still amazing that people will listen to it and then stick around.
Well, it's sort of the dialogue that's going on, not just between YouTube. That is vital. It's absolutely essential, but it sparks a dialogue that also goes on around you guys that you might not be privy to, or some folks may come to you and say, you know, what they think. But still, that the motivation is what's essential.
Well, I'm glad we could affect you in some positive way.
I've always said it from the top. That works from up here too. Also, Two-Tone. I mean, I wouldn't be. I honestly would not be playing this without the podcast either. So it's holding some, I think it's holding more than a few people together to this silly game too, because it can be really frustrating at times, especially
on your boards about somebody who's maybe gone off to the military or gone back to college or something like that. They're out of the game for a while, but they follow along, and then when the opportunity presents itself, they come back just to see what the heck you guys have been talking about.
I suppose, Tutin, you're going to say they might enjoy gardening too?
Oh, they absolutely would enjoy gardening.
You'd recommend that?
Like Ms. Roll said, it's been kind of the thing that keeps us too, you know? It's fun because, you know, we've also met a lot of fun people. So we've met you, and we've met everybody in our guild. And
and the dozens of people that I've met at your social functions alone have, you know, kept the relationships going within the game. It's that something's got to bring you back. And if this is what it takes, that's what I'll take.
It's really always fun to see at the parties, and maybe someday it would be cool if you can have a pet again that's out and about and not that you're riding.
And grazing in a garden.
All right. Well, anything else, Tutone?
Mighty Tutone.
We love seeing you. I think you must be like the last member of the GHZ Guild, right?
Yeah. You know, I was meaning to talk to you guys about that. I would like to formally petition for entry into the Yivvits and MrBubble Guild.
Let's see. There's a lot of paperwork.
Yeah, right.
But here, I'll do it really quick.
What's the last four of your social Wookiee number? Your Wookiee security number?
You know, it's written on the part of my collar where the air freshener goes.
That's a high five. Of course, buddy. Of course. Could there be any greater honor, Yivvits?
No. We would be happy to have you.
I'll try to do well. I know I'm just a pledge right at first, but maybe at 150, you guys can come on and give me a summary review.
I think we could maybe do it more like at, you know, maybe another 15 episodes or something. We can probably come back and look at that.
But you got to go for 150, guys. You can't.
No, don't say that. I'm telling people not to say that.
You must not stop. You must.
Okay.
We are all here because of you.
Whoa, screeching tight. I heard it that time. He said grand.
Did you just say grand admin?
I'm sorry. You're. We're breaking up there for a second.
Tutone, what can we say? It's episode 100. You've been a big inspiration, and we are lucky that you're at home to take our call today. We appreciate that, and immeasurable contributions, that kind of thing. So go ahead, Pat Yivvits is back now. Or do you want Pat his back?
Yivvits? Oh, I'll pat his back. Thank you back. Yep. Tutone. You're too good to us. No, because without
your
help,
we're doing all the hard work.
We wouldn't have figured out that pop filter thing and all that crap. So it takes a nudge in the right direction. And I'm glad that you've stuck around for the parties because it's lots of fun to see in the game. And of course, you can join our guild.
Okay. And now pat us on the back. Give us a nice good one. Here we go. Ready, go.
Okay. I feel like you guys live across town, not across the United States. I feel like you're that friend that I should have stopped by and seen, but I'll just call him. And I listen to your show as more of an acquaintance than a fan. And you guys have been integral to the role-playing and the party and the situation and all that.
Well, thanks. That means a lot.
Hey, Tutone, all I got to say to that is / Wookiee hug, okay, buddy? Yeah, or we'd probably do the bro hug. In real life, I'd give you like the bro hug football hug.
Are you
hug.
Sure you wouldn't do / curtsy?
No.
No, well, thank you for those kinds of, and we really appreciate it. We have a lot of fun just talking to you two, and yeah, it's these games build friendships.
Right, that's what all about the people. Oh, I might as well play my Atari. What the heck? If I'm not,
you could.
If it's just NPCs on the screen end to end, those games don't grab me much anymore.
That's right.
That's right. It's the element that you guys have been talking about for ages, which is you can do these things and you can do them by yourself and you can solo them, and that's great because some folks love that. But you don't need a wire coming out of the back of the computer for that.
No. All right, Tutone. Well, we really appreciate talking to you, and we'll keep fighting for those systems we talked about, the gardening, and I hope Grandma Min is doing well. And
yeah.
Who?
Oh, Grandma yeah. Min. Yeah. See, I thought you said Grand Admin, but
with the mic breaking.
Thanks, Tutone.
Thanks, buddy. No problem.
Wow, Tutone is just so fun to talk
to.
Love
Tutone.
We thank Tutone for everything
inspiring.
He's done for us.
Inspiring. I'm inspired now.
He's such a good safety officer, too. Safety Officer Tutone.
Yep. Railings are more expensive than cloning. They really are.
Ah.
I mean, it's like 1,200 credits to clone. It's 1,500 credits for a deck. Yeah. Or, I mean, a rail. I know what I'm going to do.
Right. Well, I don't know. That's a little bit dangerous. People might not like that idea.
The only problem is if you don't die.
Cloning's pretty painful. Oh, yeah, exactly.
Uh-huh.
Sorry, Jar Jar. Like, Jar Jar just breaks a couple legs but doesn't die. That would not be fun.
No.
So you'd kind of, like, want to make sure it's high enough so they die.
Exactly, no. Jar Jar, do you get any cake?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh,
good. Do you like it?
Are you sup?
I'm Mr. Bubble.
You're Yivvits?
And this is Yivvits.
Yeah, don't you remember us?
Hello, boyos.
Okay, all right.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah?
We do the podcast. This is episode 100 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. Yeah. You've been on it a lot. You don't remember that?
Not really, no.
Okay.
Wow. He's Jar Jar. He's
a senator. What
he's dumb.
He's in the politics. He's like,
exactly. Yeah, right. Yeah, I know. I hope he doesn't ever run for the best teen elections.
No.
That would suck. Well, look, it's been 100 episodes, I mean. Feels like 100,000,
yeah.
Right? Do you have any favorite moments? Do you want to reminisce on? Right back in the summer of 1822.
I remember having a really good experience after we watched The Phantom Menace. Because we watched it in real life and then talked about that episode. I don't know why, because it was like the podcast was fresh in my mind.
Yeah.
And then when watching the episode, we were like thinking about the podcast and jotting down notes and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And that was interesting. But then during that, I remember really being into Qui-Gon.
Really into Qui-Gon?
Yeah, I mean, like, and I'm not going off course here, you know, in that kind of...
He was just cool.
He was so cool.
Okay.
And I really respected him. I liked everything about him. And I thought he was like the coolest actor in that movie. But it went more than that. I go, because Qui-Gon is just like the coolest guy ever.
I agree.
I remember mentioning it to a friend. And that is like where I learned... I mean, I know that term has been out there forever, okay. But that's a man crush. That's where I learned what that is. I'm sure you remember me talking about that.
I remember talking about that.
And it's not like a love thing. And it's totally the definition. It's you just want to be that.
You sure you want to keep going with that?
Oh, yeah.
No, okay.
It's where I learned that concept. Like, you just want to be that person. So
right. Maybe that's where bromance came from, too.
Yeah, bromance was tied into all
the
that
bromance
stuff.
Episode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so.
So that was your favorite time was bromance and man crush?
Bingo. And then dancing. No. But I mean,
Captain Typho has more than enough men downstairs.
No, but just for memorable stuff. I mean, I just remember that one being just, to me, that was just hilarious.
Yeah, that was
just because
it kind
of tied in a lot of stuff. Yeah.
I had a lot of fun with all of them, too. There's just so many times we've had fun with
specific,
bits and
though.
Things.
Of course, but like specifically. What?
Oh, gosh. One of them would have been, I liked our episode. I don't know why, but I think I had a lot of fun with our episode about Baron Papa Noita.
I remember that one, yeah.
I don't know why. It just was kind of funny. Guess just Baron Papa Noita, you know? I mean,
what was the deal on that one?
Well, the whole deal was that was Baron Papa Noita was played by George Lucas.
Right, of course.
And it was just funny because we were talking about like his whole family being in the film and stuff. And,
that's right, because that was like new to us, I think, or so.
Yeah, we didn't know. Well, we knew it was him, but we didn't know what his name was.
Right.
And I don't remember what episode it was. I think it's the one that's still out there you can get.
Yep, I did see it.
But that was fun. And, you know, anytime we had guests on is always fun. We talked to people.
It was kind of fun trying to dig deep. Like that Baron Papa Noita, I remember like a couple of them, we would try to dig deeper for some obscure character.
So yes.
That was kind of always, always interesting. Yep. Yeah.
And 50, you know, I really enjoy Christmas episodes, too.
Oh, those are always fun
just because I know they're stressful to get done and stuff. And there's like lots of work goes into them. But when you listen to them afterwards, it's like, yeah, that's pretty good. And there's just all the little times where our guests just chime in at the right moment.
Yeah, some of the voices really... You mean the voices?
Yes.
Yeah. Sometimes they really hit the spot.
No, I don't think so.
Well, I wouldn't ask you, stupid.
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, you did. You said you were God, what is your problem?
You're killing me with that one button.
Oh, man.
That was pretty. You said, I didn't ask you, and then I didn't say anything. Like, that was you. That was you, Obi-Wan.
I didn't say anything.
Yes, it was.
What?
He's playing dumb now.
What did you say?
What?
I didn't say anything. I can understand that coming from Jar Jar.
Right.
You know,
he's like a bird brain.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. He just doesn't remember. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Jar Jar, are you stupid?
No.
What's your short-term memory?
How's your short-term memory?
He's like Big Bird on Sesame Street.
Yeah, Big Bird. But
I saw this episode. I watched Sesame Street clips, you know?
Oh, you're watching Sesame Street again.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, because you asked me about my pet was named Hooper.
Oh, right.
That's from Mr. Hooper on Sesame Street.
Okay,
I just saw one. Speaking of Big Bird, it's like Mr. Hooper tells his store employee to tell the people in the neighborhood to come to the store at noon for an announcement, right?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. And Dave is the guy who, the store employee.
Yeah.
And Dave tells Big Bird, this is going on. And then Big Bird's like, why? Is he going to like bring a balloon down from the sky and we can all hop in the balloon and get a free ride? And Dave's like, I don't know what he's doing. And so then Big Bird is running around the neighborhood telling everybody a big balloon's going to come down from the sky. So this whole, everybody in the neighborhood goes up there to,
oh my gosh,
the store that Mr. Hooper runs. And they're all excited because a big balloon's going to come down. They're going to go on a ride. And Mr. Hooper comes out. He's like, what? He whaps Big Bird. He says, you idiot. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, exactly.
But that reminded me of Charger. I don't know why.
All right, kid.
Yeah.
Well, if you want a Sesame Street story,
go to YouTube. Look at any, the classic ones are so funny.
Oh, well, let's see. Anything else you want to say about our past episodes? There's been so many of them.
Oh, I know. I'm just glad we're still doing it. I mean, glad people are listening.
We're still having those parties. Isn't that crazy?
Those, yeah. Can you imagine if our server was like those other servers, how big those parties would be? They'd be so
Nobody would be able to move. Nobody would go because it'd be so laggy.
Oh, it'd be awesome. Yeah, I hopes and dreams. I just hope our server just, bam, just takes off.
I'm glad you're here to tell us these things.
Yeah, thanks, Dark.
Well, I for
He's
one, agree with Mr.
Dark,
Bubble.
Isn't he? Yeah. No, but to me, the population and the community are, I think the game mechanics are great right now. There's a lot of potential. Everything is, I'm having a great time. I'm doing a lot of neat things that I
right.
do. And they're integrating the old stuff properly, I think. They're bringing it back. I know I've told you about the BM stuff. I mean, you know, your incubator, it needs energy. So luckily, they put in there that it requires geothermal. They didn't have to do that. They could have just had a machine that you just flip a switch and you're done. But now I have a trader out there harvesting geothermal for incubators. I mean, just things like that, they still kind of throw a bone.
Yeah.
Not a big bone, but in the big picture things, they throw it in there so you still have to have some interaction.
Well, I think, yeah, it would have been a mistake to not do that.
Well, they could easily make it so just an egg appears and you hatch an egg. You know,
right. Done. Exactly. Right? Yeah.
That's kind of interesting how they did that. And I just, again, I hope Droid Commander, same thing. Yeah, Droid should be just as fun.
But I think they should be worrying about, or at least considering, the lessons that they should learn from Beastmaster, which is that you should never make it so somebody can't own just a basic version. I mean, everybody should be able to have a pet, and God forbid they take away the ability for anybody to own a droid.
Yeah, because that's
a mistake.
They'd have to deliberately break that, yeah.
It would be very bad if you took away my mouse storage droids, or my R2 harvester that I use for harvesting hides.
Yeah.
Or my binary load lifter entertainer droid, which is an interesting combination.
Right.
I have a protocol droid that's an entertainer droid. He dances to it. Okay. Tony. Oh, I forgot I have a probe droid named Alan. I do.
Yes.
I do have a probe named.
Nice.
That's funny. Alan will be forever known as the probe droid.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Alan. Huh? I just hope that when they do that they don't break those things. I'm not saying that I'm worried that they would. But, boy, it's sure something you could really kind of overlook in a way, you know? Oops, I'm sorry, you can't have a Barker droid anymore.
And if you've played the game a while, it's easy to get lost in just the upper-level stuff and then forget about the whole damn game.
Well, yeah, yeah.
Because there's still, from 1 to 90, there's still a lot of stuff there. Just make a new tune. Just check something out.
That first, the way that the level progression works, though, it works in other games to have a quest-based level progression. Uh-huh. But, boy, you only have one quest level or one quest thing
to do. If you decide to do that, you really don't have to do the quest.
I'm not talking about for crafting. I'm talking about for combat.
Anything.
Well, grinding without the quest XP is pretty tough.
Have you tried it lately? I mean, have you actually done one lately?
No, I can't say that
I have. It brings back weird memories, and then you realize about things, and then you might appreciate quests more or just realize, boy, I don't need quests or whatever. I mean, there didn't used to be those quests. There was a game without those quests. You could sure try it without them. Not you personally, but you know, anybody out there wanting to fart around. Might learn something on the way and just encounter something that you haven't, that part of your brain hasn't been stimulated in a while.
Really?
Yeah, like I was surveying the other day, and that portion of my brain hadn't been accessed in a long time.
Sure.
Like all those graphics and that, and it's like, oh God, yeah, that's right, surveying, yeah.
Yeah.
So
you found some geothermal and you're like,
hello, what have we here?
Yeah, it's like 12%. That's good, isn't it?
Oh yeah, 12 OQ. Yeah.
No, the amount of it in the ground.
Sure, yeah. That, well, I mean, you just harvest less. It's the old queue you got to worry about.
That's true. Yeah. It's just, I'm
sorry,
having
am I interrupting anything?
No, it's okay, Lando. We'll just, yeah.
You look absolutely beautiful.
Oh, he just wanted to come in here and tell us that, I guess.
Wow, thanks, Lando.
You truly belong here with us among the clouds.
Thank you. Tabana gas.
He's always...
Mine Tabana gas. That'd be fun.
Tabasco gas. And he's always here among the clouds. I like
you. Join me for a little refreshment?
We just had some cake. Sorry.
No, but there's just a lot of stuff in the game still to do. It's still a world. You know, I played Conan for a month, and I have no problem with Conan, except it's just focused on leveling to get the higher armor, to get the higher weapon, to kill the bigger bad guys. And that's fun. I have no problem with that, but that's a different game. And I kept hearing, you know, Star Wars is still the world. That's my first big MMO that I got into. And it's like you stand up, like at one of Saipam's parties she did yesterday, you stand on the edge and look down at the valley below. I mean, that's powerful, because in the distance I could see some buildings. I know those buildings were dropped by players.
Not instanced.
Right. They were sitting right there, and they were like 1,500 meters away. I purposely went there to have it load, and then I went back to the party site. And I could still see these tiny, so I knew they were there. And I knew I could, if I wanted, I'd hop in my jetpack and fly down there and go inside and look at the paintings on the wall, which they put up there, and then fly back to the party with my ribbons hanging out, which is always fun to do on a jetpack.
Your ribbons, right.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. But anyway, and that's my point. I mean, it's just, traitor, it's such a pain in the ass to grind, but I'm doing it, and I probably won't make it. I need to make 82 so I can do a certain thing, but.
Right.
Blah.
That's a long way.
Anyway, my point is, there's still a lot of stuff to there.
There's value.
A lot of people. Like our cantina, I mentioned, was really dead. I just sat there on the wall with one of my anonymous alts, and just sat there and talked to people. And if you want to have a thriving, alive world, you got to have people sitting on the wall talking to people. And that worked. People were talking. True. There were a couple old timers in there. I was actually there when someone who had not played in 3 years logged on and said, "What's this? What's this? What's this?" And then that player saw someone else and said, "Oh my God, are you so and so from this guild? That was like my first guild, and that was like 3 years ago." And I was there for that moment. So a lot of that's coming back.
Oh, that's good. That's good. That's good that people do that. And then they log in and they log out because nobody's around.
Yes.
And that's the part we got to fix.
Yeah. Just play. I mean, play.
Just get out there and play. Yeah. I mean, EQ too, I always talk about sometimes too. And you're right. It does have that feeling that everybody's just trying to get to the goal.
Mm-hmm.
And
like a sprint.
The thing is, I found ways to work around that to some degree so I can have a little bit of fun. But it definitely isn't the same kind of world that Star Wars Galaxies is.
Even if the graphics, like, I'm back to Conan, because as I said, I did try that for a solid month. I mean, the graphics are up a notch, and I still will play Conan, but it's still not alive to me in the same way.
Right. Doesn't have that feeling.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. And I think it's kind of like that house stuff I mentioned. I mean, that is huge. And the towns and the mayors and all that, that's all pretty huge.
It doesn't exist in other games to that degree, does it? So that's why, to me, it's the grand experiment. I mean,
and entertaining.
That ribbons. But, people give Raph Koster a lot of crap.
Drink Coaster.
They say things like, well, he never finishes what he starts, and, he's got these grand things, but they're so complicated. And it's like, well, yeah, but look at this. I mean, this is an experiment that nobody knew what this kind of game could be like when he designed it.
Well, like what Alan said, right.
I just hear too often, I hear people making excuses as to why, his plan doesn't or didn't work. And I think that it can work in other games in the future, too, because it is something more compelling. And maybe not to everybody, but to a lot of people, it is. Because what do they keep coming back to? I mean, they get sick of whatever the game is, and they go back there because they can always do something different.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do another voicemail.
Hey, guys, it's Al McGill. Just popping by to say congratulations on reaching 100 episodes and to say thanks very much for hundreds of hours of fun information. Laughs, sound effects, well, all the stuff in the podcast. It's been awesome. Really looking forward to another 100? 200? As long as there's a game, there'll be a Yivvits and MrBubble, eh? You've come a long way since, the basement to your own studio now. And you no longer have to talk through women's underwear, which has got to be an improvement. I mean, seriously, the game's changed a lot over time. It's seen people come, it's seen people go. But the podcasts have always been there, and you guys have kept going, kept the parties going, kept your community going, which is important. And, probably more than anyone else who's have turned the game around. It's not those devs and all those things are changing behind the scenes and bits that they're upgrading and bits they're dropping out, new quests, all that stuff. It's Yivvits and MrBubble. I mean, totally, without that, there would be no Star Wars Galaxies. Well, okay, maybe those guys had a little bit to do with it. But they haven't done 100 freaking podcasts, have they? Seriously. Take care, guys. Really look forward to meeting you one day. And is it time for 101 yet?
Congratulations to Yivvits and MrBubble on recording their 100th Star Wars Galaxies podcast from everyone at Staggering Stories.
Woo! Good growing there!
They're very good.
They are. Oh. They are. It's a phenomenal amount of podcasts.
Mm-hmm. Like sexual tension between them.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. What's things you can do with a lightsaber?
I know.
I'm Alan.
I'm Alan.
I'm Alan.
I'm Alan.
Welcome to the Star Wars Galaxy with Yivvits and MrBubble. Hello, I'm Nassie Ace.
And I'm Al Ace, and we are MMO sisters.
Yes, and we are friends that play Star Wars Galaxy with Yivvits and MrBubble on the Velsen server. In the news, Yivvits and MrBubble is celebrating their 100th podcast. We know this rocks, and you guys rock too. Big Wookiee hugs and kisses from Nassie and Al. BFF and MMO sisters.
Yivvits, buddy.
MrBubble.
We did 100 of these damn things. We didn't do any history segment because, like, remember they started on the kitchen table? You can listen to episode 50. We do a nice rundown.
Exactly. It's an additive thing.
I guarantee you, that day I was not saying let's do this for 3 years, but it's brought me a lot of stuff in life, and I'm very, very happy we did it.
Well,
I mean that sincerely.
I am happy too. It's been a lot of fun with you and hanging out, and it's just fun to keep us both playing too. We've come a long way as far as from the kitchen to the basement to the upstairs, and I don't know where it's going to be next.
Oh, outdoors, backyard. Oh,
hey, in the winter? I don't know if that's... Yeah. No, I don't think so.
I think with your mobile toy, we're going to be a little more remote.
I think you just can't. Yeah. Well, that's true. Yep. We can do more on-the-road things.
I think, you mentioned in the break, I think we're just going to be like at the Mexican restaurant talking about Star Wars, and you'll hear an episode with that someday.
Jeeps.
More chips, amigo.
And our place has the awesome chips.
Oh, yes.
You know the owner.
Tranquilino, yes.
He's a great guy. Every time I go in there.
He taught me to count. I was asking him
did
about
he really?
Count.
Well,
yeah.
Or was that Sesame Street? You don't want to get the two confused.
Right. That was Maria on Sesame Street.
It might have been.
She's a fox.
Mm-hmm. So, there's all sorts of things. I think we'll probably do some more stuff with, we'll be talking to players more.
More social stuff. I think you're right. Who knows what we're going to
do? Well, we always say it's all about the people.
And yeah, unless we should make it more about the people.
And we should make it more about the people. And I know politicians say that all the time, but
yeah, well, we really mean it. I mean, I think if we're going to turn our knobs here,
I agree.
I'm talking about our dials, not our knobs. But
like this guy?
Yeah. Right.
Turn your knobs.
If we're going to tweak those knobs.
Tweak the knobs.
Turn the community knob up. I'd turn Sony down a little. I mean, Sony's the guys that make the game. It's, because there are other games coming out. And if the community shifts to the other Star Wars games...
So we're going
to
just do a little, like that much, down? Like...
Well, just, I mean, for our ongoing...
How much?
For our ongoing focus, put it from D to C on that one, and then this one from F to G.
This one goes like... That one goes up more.
No, because what fuels Sony and that one, they want the community stuff from us. That's the fuel for them.
Right.
So
that's
cool. I mean, that should be up a little bit.
Well, we're always going to talk about what we're doing in the game, what we find interesting. So
yeah.
I mean, that's not any different. It's fun to talk to people too.
Community. Yep.
We've talked to Alan. Talked to Two Tone. There's all sorts of crazy people out there like that.
Well, that was very deliberate. Yeah, we picked one from Sony and one of the fan base.
Oh no, it was just random. What are you talking about?
Well, that's true.
Alan just called in.
Okay,
We didn't know he was going to call.
Yep.
Deliberate.
Right.
Jeez.
I didn't say anything.
Deliberately. Obi-Wan?
I didn't say anything.
Oh, yes, you did.
Thanks for the cake, Branlow.
Yum.
It was beautiful
that's
cake.
True. That was his cake.
That was beautiful cake. Oh, thanks, guys.
And thank you, Obi-Wan, for not revealing the secret.
I didn't say anything.
I know. I thank you, buddy.
Thank you.
Thank you. We really appreciate it, and it's just good to have you.
Good job.
It was a pretty good show. Yeah. It was not too bad. It's been great to see all of our guests and Watt and the Tauntaun. Tauntaun's over there sleeping. I think he's had a little bit too much sugar.
Wait a minute.
What?
I got some on my fingers right here.
Oh, come over here, Tauntaun-y.
Relax. Stop that.
Thanks to Han and all of our usual guests. They always come. Yeah. It's such nice and see us. And I think Kleeg had something he wanted to tell you before he leaves.
Yes, Kleeg. What is it?
You were the most loving partner a man could ever have.
You know.
Okay.
We have a lot to talk about.
Okay, Kleeg.
We should go inside.
Do we say we'll do another voicemail?
Yeah.
We got another one here?
I think this might be the last one. One more, yep.
Okay.
Hey, guys. This is Ambassador Kosh. Calling to wish you a happy 100th episode. Congratulations. Keep it up, guys.
Hi, I'm not Alan. This is Rago. And congratulations on your 100th episode. You guys rock.
Hey, guys. It's Redheaded Tim here. I was told I should call this number and say congratulations on reaching your milestone. Not that I expected any less from two people so wise, so powerful.
Hey, Yivvits MrB, this is Dead Meat calling. Just wish you a happy 100th anniversary. You guys do a great job. Love your show. Keep it up. Take care, guys.
Hi, Wookie Lovin. Hey, I'm Alan.
Hello, Yivvits and MrBubble. Happy 100th episode from Iko's iPod and his dormant account on the Bloodfin Galaxy. I'm Alan.
Today is September 7th, 2008, and even though Yivvits MrBubble put off episode 100 with more fanfare reports, I'm Alan. Happy 100th, guys. You guys are great. I love listening to your show. You make my dull work day much better with Yivvits' Captain Stahlmeyer impersonation and MrBubble going on about Hello Kitty. Wait, what's this podcast about? Oh, yes, and lots of Star Wars. I'm really excited you guys made it to the big 100th. Can't wait till I call in for the number 200, which would be what, 2035? I don't know. Anyway, enjoy the glory that is basking upon you at this point, because let's face it, this is probably the highlight, right? I'll see you guys. Bye.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble, this is Biko. I just wanted to congratulate you guys on your 100th episode. Wow, 100 episodes, that's crazy. Even though I don't play the game anymore, I never miss an episode. I wanted to thank you guys for all the time, energy, and hard work you put into each and every episode. Thanks for all the great hours of entertainment that you've given us. And if you do decide to continue on, you'll always have a listener in me. God bless you guys. Bye.
Hi, this is John Smedley from Sony Online Entertainment. I'd like to give you guys a big shout-out on your 100th episode. You guys are a terrific part of the fan community for Star Wars Galaxies, and everybody here at SOE appreciates it. Thanks very much.
Well, thanks, everybody, for all your voicemails. We really love them. It's just great to hear from all of you. And
keep calling.
We thank you for all of your support and coming to our parties and all the people that listen and never play Star Wars Galaxies. You guys are awesome. Everybody's awesome. And thanks, everybody at Sony, too.
And
all the names. See, I can do that, too.
SWIGpodcast.com, Yivvits and MrBubble.com, 888-900-YAMB, or comments at Yivvits and MrBubble.com.
That's what you can call, and you can email
us.
Let us
know what's up.
And you can leave us a happy 100th message. Maybe it's a little late for that now. I really do hope that we can get that support for the gardening thing.
Oh my God! By then, yeah.
And give us pets that we can have without any BM points. Jeez,
right?
Good Lord! Oh, you know, some people probably shouldn't own pets if they have no pet experience. But that's real life. I mean, anybody in Star Wars Galaxy.
Oh
would
be yeah, able to, good yeah. point. Good point. Yeah,
some people are like, I got a dog. Thanks, MrBubble. It's always a pleasure.
Yes, this has
and
been fun.
I appreciate your work with me on this yeah. and all that stuff. And I appreciate you.
You better. No, I'm kidding. We'll have
well,
fun
I
in the future.
Say that enough, but
I know.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, buddy. Hug. Thank you. Wookie hug. Oh, what a good hug. Oh,
that wasn't yes. my Wookie sound. That was my stomach. Oh. I'm hungry again.
Oh, baby.
Sorry, am I interrupting anything?
No, we're just finishing up
just
here.
Just having a bromance.
We're just finishing up here.
You look absolutely beautiful.
Thank you. Oh. I thought he meant me.
No, he was. I think he was talking to me.
I swear it was me, Lando.
You look absolutely beautiful.
All right, everybody. You keep playing, and we'll keep playing. That's a deal, right?
Deal. We literally have a cake in my fridge right now that says "Happy Birthday, Brenlo."
Well, I can do that. I prefer chocolate cake. If you'd like.
No.
We want your honest reaction. But I swear to God, I had to go to a grocery store in town here and say, "Yeah, Happy Birthday, Brenlo. Your pals at SOE," and they're like, "Okay." They didn't care.
I wish they had holodecks. I would be there playing with data, you know.
I mean, certainly.
When
certainly.
They did the Robin Hood episode, that'd be fun.
Oh.
Speaking of that, I have a picture of you on my desk here.
Right.
Of you dressed up in some kind of a Robin Hood outfit.
What?
Yeah. I don't know where I found it, but it's a picture you're on, like, dressed up like, I don't know.
Like a Ren Faire kind of picture.
Oh, yes. Curse you, Amy.
That's like the biggest conflict in the galaxy. The fact that Dancing with the Stars conflicts with the heroes. Am I right?
Yes, you're right. Spoken like a true Celestine entertainer.
I'm not kidding. My team was like, oh.
It's a good thing it can do two things at once.
I know.
It depends on which season of the Dana Troy outfit you can use.
That'd be season 3.
Season 1?
The correct answer is season 3.
Not the
3.
Little short dress from the first episode?
Season 3. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
You go, hey, I want to play in Peter Pan's world today. You
my favorite.
Hang out with the Lost Boys.
Say it again. That'd be a great soundbite.
Oh, I think I got it.
I think you did. There's a little bit at the end. I think
oh,
I
you too.
I think I walked down.
I should have known.
I want to play in Peter Pan's world today.
But I did agree with him, so I mean.
Me too. I always.
Well, guys, it's not so much a matter of where, but when. When are we?
Okay, try it again.
That's not such a much. It's not such a question of when. Well, guys, it's not so much a matter of a. Well, guys, it's not such a question of when. Ah.
It's okay.
I'm Alan, and here's your birthday boy.
Yeah, but he's not wearing any clothes.
Dum da dum dum da da do. I like to play the fay.
Quit laughing, God.
Just come in. Look, I like the dum da dum da dum. Like, who's the birthday boy? Who, you know, something like that. It's he doesn't have cake. Show me your birth. Where my birthday? Where's my birthday?
Show me my birthday gifts.
Right. Exactly.
I was the closest thing to an admin at New because, you know, my connection with the Matrix Online and all.
Oh, and the forums too, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. We're running lithium again, by the way. Lithium forums are better than ever.
Yeah, true. Can I use my HTML signatures?
No.
Oh, damn.
You can't use tables either.
Oh.
Not yet.
Okay.
We're working on that.
All right.
We just got RSS feeds last year. Well, the cake. Oh, wait, the Tauntaun wants cake. Here, do you want to give him some cake?
Well, I'm licking my fingers.
Oops.
And yes. Do they use Yivvits' mom's pantyhose still, or what do they use?
You know, I'm not sure about that particular supply line, but...
It's very rare to get those, but they do have the best sound.
They're no trade also.
Yeah, they're no trade. Nice.
Sorry.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mom.
I suppose it depends on the interface. They keep getting better and better and more realistic, and you know.
Not the Star Wars Galaxies user interface. Yivvits unified theory of gaming, and that is that no expectation equals no disappointment.
Oh.
No expectation equals no disappointment. That's my unified gaming theory.
That used to be my dating theory, too.
No, that was the people that were dating you.
Right. Okay, thank you. Three.
Sorry, am I interrupting anything?
Thank you. Oh. Wait,
like, countdown, then we'll go. Like, we'll both think he's talking just to
us.
Oh,
okay. One, two. Thank you.
You go one, two, three, then thank you.
Yeah, it was. But I don't say three or whatever, because...
Okay.
Well...
How am I supposed to know that? All right.
Well, that's because I did it the last time.
Go ahead.
One, two... Three.
This is definitely outtake material. Okay, what you doing this time?
Well, either way, I was still counting to three.
Right, but I was waiting. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to count. I'm going to say out loud mm-hmm. one, two, three, and then say it.
Okay, to Lando, like we both think that he's saying thank you, or beautiful yes. just to us. Okay.
One, two,
four.
One. two, three.
Thank you. Oh, I thought he meant me.
No, he was. I think he was talking to me.
I swear it was me, Lando.
You look absolutely beautiful.